are Crone, Amazon, JZD, Horsch, and they'll all be competing today to get into the qualifiers. I also have Laz with me today, commentating with me today. How are you doing, Laz?
I'm fine. Hello, everyone. Yep.
Yeah, welcome to the stream.
I think we are here for the first time in like 8 months or something that we two cast together. It has been a long time, dude.
I think last time we did it was probably at Gamescom or something like that.
Yeah, something like that. So, well, that would even be a year. Nice to be back with you.
Yeah, it's nice to be with you. So yeah, today we have got Crone first of all and Amazon. I guess we could chat about those. They are like 400 points different in circuit points, so that'd be quite interesting to see.
Yeah, the whole group will be interesting because we do have JZD here, right? And these guys are powerhouse, so everyone expect them to win. However, they have never been able to beat Amazon. Amazon has only played them once, to be fair, but they won. So while Amazon is the complete underdog, I'd say, together with Horsch, they still stand a chance. So this group might be super interesting.
Yeah, and for people wondering as well, it's going to be three matches. It's best of three with each team today. But we're thinking it's probably going to be two with Crone and Amazon, but who knows? Anything could happen. I'm thinking like group stage A, I think Trelborg was beat by one of the other teams then. So they could be beat. I guess we'll see. We'll see how it goes.
I remember Alex and me sitting here going, okay, we have Trelleborg versus Team of Elite Guys first. That will be a quick one. And then we take care of the real games. And then Team of Elite Guys just destroyed Trelleborg 2-0. We didn't know what to say. So everything can happen. This is Worlds. Neither Trelleborg nor John Deere made it out of groups as the first seed. John Deere got beaten by the Burning Gamers last week. And Trelleborg obviously got beaten by Team of Elite Guys.
Yeah.
So everything can happen. We expect JCD and Crone to go through because they seemingly be the strongest teams here, but we will see. It'll be interesting.
Yeah, and whoever goes through, I think they're going to be going against John Deere as well. I think if Crone goes through, I think they're probably going with John Deere.
If you finish first, the way that works now is the first seed here will play the second seed of Group B, which would be John Deere. So if you win this group, you are against John Deere in the quarters. The second seed here will go against the first seed of Group B. So that would be the Burning Gamers by Stark. So if you finish second, you're against the Burning Gamers. And like two weeks ago, everyone would have chosen the Burning Gamers over John Deere. But after the Burning Gamers just destroyed John Deere last week, I'm not sure I would do that. I don't want to face the Burning Gamers right now.
Yeah, I guess we'll see what goes. We also have in the second match today, we have JZD versus Horsch. They are 160 points different in circuit points. I think they're pretty close. I guess we'll see how it goes. But you say that JZD are pretty good. They are pretty good. They're a pretty good team. So we'll see. Yeah. We'll see what happens. I guess it's. I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be a good game.
It will be a good game. It is probably one of the closer groups. And the two groups that weren't too close, that were Group A and B, they were super close in the end. So now that we have the groups that seem to be closer with C and D, it will be super interesting to see what's going to happen. So I can't wait to see how they compete today. As we said, we expect Crone and JZD to make quick work of the others, but Horsch has surprised us before. Like they have their own they invented the Gamescom tactic, the Horsch tactic.
Yeah, when there was pushing one of the combines, right? At one point.
Yeah, exactly.
They managed to figure out how to do that.
They come up with now, right? They might just have something that they can pull out now to make it through and go to the world quarters. Who knows?
Yeah, who knows? We might get to see some new tactics for them. We also saw Class last week. They obviously failed. They didn't get through. They're a good team, but they failed last week. They never actually changed the tactics. They did three games. We were talking with VF last week, and they went through three different games, and they never changed the tactics. They were sticking to the same tactics, and they didn't change anything up last week, so... they failed last week. So yeah, a bit of bad news there for them. We also saw last week Harvest Streaks and Baylor Streaks, and sometimes all at once as well. We had Baylor Streaks and Harvest Streaks at the same time, combined streaks. So yeah, we might see that again today. That definitely spices things up.
Talking about things that are weird, we are getting a message from our tech team right now that there is a problem on Amazon's side. Amazon seemingly is not able to join the servers due to some internet problems. We are not sure what's going on there. However, they had they do have like 10 seconds left. And that's basically a win for Crone. So this game is over already, even before it started, because one of the teams is just not able to play at all. So congratulations, Crone. That was even faster than we expected it to be.
Okay, so everyone. So essentially, everyone. A win for Crone because Amazon is unable to connect to the internet. So Krona's, because Krona has more circuit points currently, they're much higher, like 400 points higher. It's going to go straight to those today for the Krona. So yeah, that team's already done.
Super sad, but I mean, the way it is, this tournament would usually be offline, right? But due to the current situation in the world, we simply can't have them sitting together somewhere and play. So everyone has to connect to the internet. And of course, we've done a lot of tech tests over the last week, making sure all the teams can connect, have a stable internet and everything. However, the online rules still apply. And that means that if on tournament day, you are not able to connect in time, you lose, basically.
Yeah.
And as Krona would be the opponent, they win. It's just what it is. So for Amazon, it's not over. For Amazon, that means they have time to fix whatever the issue is until they have to play in the loser bracket later today. If they can't make it, they're going to lose that one as well and drop out of the tournament. So let's hope they can fix it, because that's just sad.
Yeah, fingers crossed. That's we'll see how it goes. But first of all, we're going to have JZD versus Horsch. We're going to go in straight to those today.
Yeah.
And you can see those in the bottom right just there.
Yeah, exactly. This is new.
Yeah, this is actually a new thing in the bottom right just there. We can actually see how the game's looking currently before we actually jump in and watch them choose the tracks and things.
So teams are still getting ready. You can see on the bottom right that they are in the lobby. So that means that we have like another maybe 30, 40 seconds until the game starts. And all the other teams should be fairly happy with what happened here, because if Amazon can't make it, that means that you automatically won, right? Every team will automatically win, because let's just say that, I don't know, let's say Horsch wins, just to mix things up a bit. If Horsch wins that one and JCD loses, JCD has to face Amazon, and that means they won, basically.
Yeah.
For Amazon, they have like an hour to fix these things. And I really hope they do, because this is just sad.
Let's hope they fix it, because this is... it's not great, but I guess they'll be looking into it over the next hour or so.
For sure. But can you imagine playing an entire season, making it to World Championships,
and then
something goes so wrong that you can't make it? This is just sad. But let's face on let's focus on that one.
Let's look on the good side.
Versus Horsch.
So the very first stage, everyone. This is where they essentially ban the vehicles. So as we always see them banning the JCBs. I guess we'll see if they do that right now.
Yeah, they will. I'm sure the JCB will not go through. This thing just never does.
Yeah.
Neither does the Deutz, usually. And that one is gone already. I'm really interested to see if Horsch has something in stock, because they haven't been good lately. The last tournaments, they just... Well, they haven't found to form ever since Gamescom, basically. But they have a good team. They had previously one of the best stackers in the league with Deutz Freak. He isn't as great anymore because he lacks practice due to him moving to the countryside and not having the internet to practice all the time, which is a super weird thing to happen, but it just happened. They do have a good team. Marcel being the team captain today.
Yep.
And so you can see Niggles is not here.
Yeah, and this right now, this is currently the picking and banning stage. They're currently picking the vehicles. They've banned the vehicles. You can see now they're picking them. We have 50 seconds left. And for any of the new people in chat that are watching, this is where they pick the vehicles to play in this round. Every vehicle acts differently. They have different horsepowers, different speeds and different maneuverabilities and things like that. So, it's very, they usually pick the ones they want to use. And you can see they're picking the one. They just picked a Case Puma. There you go, with the Care Wheels.
And just to mention this very quickly, because I've seen it in the chat a couple of times. Yeah, you are not seeing us. Joe and me, we are at home, basically. The reason for that is that due to the current situation, as you can imagine, we can't fly people in from England. It's just impossible right now with all the things that are going on. And it would just be too dangerous, basically. We shouldn't.
Yep.
So that's why you see the German casters on stream. So the two guys you see talking, if they are talking, it's not us. You can hear us, but we are at home in our safe environments because...
They're the German castles, right?
Because I've seen a couple of guys being here for the first time and going like, this is super asynchrone. The sound is just messed up. It's not. It's just not us.
Anyway, we're going into the game. We have 15 minutes. That's the length of each match. And here we go. So let's see what takes place. So you can see this is JZD currently. They're heading over to... Seems like they're going over to the Krone Baylor just there, and also the John Deere Combine. We'll see if they get it.
They will get the Krone for sure. They are fast. The way that works for people who watch for the first time is these 8 black pots you can see there, they have 4 balers and 4 harvesters on them, and every vehicle that's on them can only pick once. Like this red one that Monty has, the case, if he drives that one off that pot, that means that JCD can't pick it anymore, right? So you need to get this stuff as fast as possible. The more you have, the less the other team can get. And that's why you can see all the people rushing down and getting everything they can right now.
And I was just going to say, I'm talking about getting things off the pods. Last week, John Deere actually didn't manage to do it. They jumped out of the combine when the pipe was still over the pod. Yeah. So they lost the John Deere combine. So just if you guys can remember that in the chat from last week. So hopefully that doesn't happen today.
And you can see the red flashing lights, right? The combine is still there. It's still on the pod. However, you can't pick it anymore. The lights are red. That means the opponent has claimed it on their side of the field. So you can't claim it anymore. Both teams have 2 combine harvesters, though. So it's quite fair. We have the Ideal and the John Deere for JCD, so they got at least the bigger ones.
Yeah, I mean, the Ideal, that is
that make anything, any difference.
Yeah, the Ideal, that has the biggest tank in the combines. And then they also have the baler as well, which obviously produces 3 bales at once. So yeah, pretty cool stuff.
Yeah, but then again, the Fend press is on side of Horsch, which is the fastest press in the game. I think they also got the Coon, and that one has been buffed recently. So it's a bit better than it used to be. Wait. So fair setup here, fair setup.
Yeah, you can see just there, everyone, this is the Fent baler just going past. Pretty cool baler. Okay. All right, so it's 13 minutes. Nobody's scored a bale yet.
That will change right now because Melly is on his way and might score and get the first bale. Because first bale scored, yeah, he does.
Is he heading to the bottom bale? Yeah, he's heading to the bottom. This will be 20 points because the first bale is always double.
Oh, so that was nice. That
was 20
just
points.
Just making sure only one goes in. The way that works, guys, is... you score points by putting bales into your barn. The barn, as you might have seen, has 2 gates, the lower gate and the upper gate. The lower gate means that the bale scores 10 points, and the upper gate that you need to use the conveyor belt for scores 10 points times the multiplier you see on the top, well, middle of the screen. Is that the right English phrase? It's 2.0 for both teams right now because it's the beginning of the game. That might change, and as soon as it changes, we're going to explain how that works.
So yeah, the drone drops as well, for people wondering in the chat, because I know there's some new people in it. There's a drone that comes over around the 6 to 8 minute mark, and essentially it drops some, wheat value and also bale points as well. You can either pick, each team can pick which one, and it affects both teams when they pick it. And essentially if they pick wheat value, it means the multiplier can go up as well, so they can get some better points, and also the grain boost as well. For the bales, obviously the bale points will go up. So
Exactly. Yeah,
we'll probably see that in a few minutes.
There's one other thing to mention, and these are the drawbridges. You might have seen the guys driving over drawbridges. Boy. Yep. And these drawbridges are linked to each other. That means that if you drive over a drawbridge, that drawbridge will go up, but so will the drawbridge on the opposing team's side. So if, like now, if Mr. Marcel drives over that one, it will go up, and the blue version of it will go up as well, basically blocking the way for JZD, as you can see here. So they can't take that road and have to go with the detour, and it takes longer.
Oh, it just crashed. that's a pretty cool thing. I like that because, that could be just one of the tactics that the teams could play. They could be looking over the other side of the field and see that another team's just about to go over it with some bales maybe, and they could drive over theirs and start raising it. So, yeah, pretty cool stuff.
Yeah. And if you could follow so far, then you pretty much have an idea of what's going on here. There are a lot of tiny things that will... basically change the outcome, but we will go over them as soon as possible. One being the drone drop that is like 3 minutes away, maybe 5, but at least 3 minutes.
Yep. And also you have this auger trailer as well. What the teams like to do is open the auger trailer up to get all the grain in there. And the key is to get the grain in there pretty soon. They'll probably be doing that in a few minutes or so. And they'll then take that over to the sell points to sell the grain. And that will then increase their multiplier. And obviously, it'll obviously negatively impact the other team as well in terms of their conveyor belt. So, yes. So, yeah, lots of different cool things going on. We're currently hitting the 10-minute mark.
Yeah, usually around the 10-minute mark, you're going to see people switching from 2 harvesters to just 1. So having one dedicated player switching harvesters, unloading one while driving with the other. That is because you really need to get the bales in position to be able to get the points. And because as Joe said, there is a drone drop. That one might happen between minute 8 and 6. And if they do that and you get bale boost, which means that every bale scores 30 points if it goes into the upper gate, you really need to have the Bales ready, because if your opposing team picks that one and you don't have Bales, you're going to lose the match. So yep. That's why they usually switch around to a one harvester tactic at around the 10 to 9 minute mark, so we should see fairly soon and get everything in position just in case the drone drop happens.
Yeah. Somebody's asking where Virtual Farmer is. Virtual Farmer isn't doing it this week, but it will be here next week as well. So yeah, he was here last week. He's not this week, but he is next week. So don't worry, everyone. He'll be back with us next week as well.
Yeah. For now, it's me. Next week, it's Joe and Virtual Farmer.
Yeah, Lars is pretty good. He knows a lot of the ins and outs with the FSL. So yeah, we'll learn a lot of cool things from Lars today.
Yeah, and most of the people should have listened to me before, because every time one of you guys can't make it, I'm the one jumping in.
Yep.
I'm basically the substitute caster. But yeah, due to me, basically, I'm one of the referees for this game, so, and one of the creators, basically. So, you know, I have a rough idea of what's going on. I let Joe do the cool talking, and I try to explain things. Or the other way around, who knows.
Yep. You can see one of the teams just there. I think that was Team Horsch. I think Team Horsch are already starting to unload their grain. And you can see JZD just there. They're not unloading the grain currently. You can see just over there the case.
They didn't even open up the Horsch so far.
I know, they're just opening it up. And this is the thing, everyone. If the teams need to get the grain in, because if another team gets to the unload point before them, you know, it can impact them, depending on how much grain they have. If another team has more grain in the trail than them, in the end, once all the grain's unloaded, that team will be winning with the multiplier. So, yeah. We'll see how they're going. You can see they're currently picking the bales up. And the key, really, right now in this sort of time frame is just getting as many bales as they can over to the shed to start loading them up and scoring the points in a few minutes' time.
Absolutely. And you can see that Horsch already is driving with just one harvester. They switched like a minute ago. For JZD, they will start doing the same now. Hyper jumped out of his harvester, and I don't know where he is on the field. He's not in the tractor right now. Probably grabbing one. And yeah, he did that now, grabbed the Steyr so that they can move the Horsch around when they want. And that's exactly what I've mentioned before, right? You unload one, you jump into the other, and keep driving.
Yep, Team Horsch just
seconds, you lose.
Yep, Team Horsch just there, you can see they're already loading some more bales up at the shed, at the barn just here. And, I mean, the drone drop actually can take place any minute now. But in the time frame of the drone drop, so we need to keep lookout for that.
Yeah, and this drone is in the theoretical middle point between all three players. So
yes, it's like a
by
triangle,
sticking
right?
together, and you can see that at least the JCD team is more or less sticking together, while Horsch is just super scattered about around the field. You can make sure that you are closer to the drop, because if you pick it, as Joe said before, the other team is locked for it as well. So if you pick Bale Boost, for example, it works for both teams, and the other team can't choose anything anymore.
Yeah, I think last week was in a position where one team needed to have one of the bale points, one of the drone drops, and another team needed the other one. And yeah, I mean, when you're in that situation, both teams need to get to the one they need to get to, or it's going to impact them pretty bad. So yeah.
You can see it here. The drone is right there, and Hyper and Melly are just there waiting. Everyone is right next to the drone, making sure that drone is super close. And they are now just waiting to make sure that they get whatever they want and push Horsch out of their tactic, basically.
There we go.
And there it is.
And they've got the grain boost.
They got the grain boost.
Nice.
So, do you want to explain grain boost?
Yeah, we can do that. Oh, okay, both. Essentially, what will happen right now is they're going to take the auger trailer over to the unload points, and they'll start unloading. That will then increase their multiplier. It'll make the other team's conveyor belt faster, and obviously, it will also increase their bale points as well, times their multiplier. So, I think there's some more to it. You can just talk about that.
And then, the way that works is, usually if you increase, and we're going to see that right now, if you increase your multiplier and decrease the one of the opposing team, the higher you want to increase your multiplier, the more grain you need.
Yep.
It just gets more expensive with pretty much every 0.1% point you get. However, doing the grain boost window, which is like roughly another minute and 20 seconds, there is no increase. So it just stays cheap, and you can see it here, how fast the multiplier just goes up.
Yeah,
so that's why they picked it. They want to make sure that the multiplier is in favor of JZD. And for now, it is.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. I mean, when the team's multiplier goes up, their bales obviously are times by their multiplier.
Oh, I love that.
So, yeah, so it's just awesome, really. I mean, obviously, the bales points are just going to go up higher and higher. And the other team's bale points aren't as high anymore because of the multiplier. So you can see both teams now are both unloading at the same time. They're both fighting over the unload point.
And I love how JCT just kept it at 1.1, because the one thing you don't want to do is if you increase your multiplayer to 3.0, it goes down to 1.0 for the opposing team and their belt stops. Yeah. But you don't want to have the belt stop, because if you have the belt stop, they can just fill the belt with bales and then, you know, start unloading and getting running again. But if you keep it at 1.1, if you put a bale on that basically for later, it just goes super fast and gives you 11 points. And you don't want to have 11 points. You want more. Yeah, so that was very clever for JCD. Advantage JCD, and you can tell that these guys are exactly... They know exactly what they do. They have a multiplayer of 2.3 right now, which is a lot. And they get ready to take this first match.
Yeah, I've just come up with like a new idea. Maybe you could put the bales on when the conveyor belt's going really fast and all the bales start falling off because the conveyor belt's going so fast. That'd be quite a cool thing.
Actually, you would be happy, I think. It's better they fall off than they go in for 11 points, because really don't want 11 points. That's a bale wasted.
Are they loading up three bales just there?
Yes, they do.
Oh, wow.
I think John Deere invented the three bale tactic, but a lot of teams picked it up, especially the ones with good stackers. JCT obviously having one of the best stackers in the league. They can totally do that, and they put a lot of pressure on Horsch.
Yeah, three bales just there. And what happens is the bottom one will go in first, and then they'll all drop down like that. It's pretty awesome.
It's very nice.
I think last week we saw somebody do four bales, and it doesn't work. Four bales don't work.
It didn't. It can work. I've seen it in practice runs.
Yep.
But it's hard to do. It has to be super precise for it. And they wanted to show off, and it didn't work. It's one of these things, like, if it works, you are the genius of the game, you know? If it doesn't work, everyone is like, what an idiot.
All it takes is for your bale just to be a little bit wonky, you know, in the wrong direction, and your bale it'll just drop off. We saw that quite a few times last week. It's not good for the team when that happens.
No, and it happens a lot. Like, these things have to be precise. That's why the stacker is such an important position in this game. If you don't know how to stack these things nicely, as you can see here, you won't make points. They will just fall off. And if they fall off, it's just 0 points. Of course, you can pick them up again and put them back on the belt, but that just eats time, and you don't have that. There's only 2:40 left. JCT is leading by about 250 points, so Horsch needs to do something about it right now. But with that multiplier, I don't know what they want
to
do.
Yeah, we're coming up to the 2-minute mark, which this is when things start getting a little bit intense, everyone. Both teams, we're coming up to the end now, and both teams really want to get these bales on. JCT currently winning at 462 points. Horsch at 186, and the multiplier is still up in JZD's favor as well. So they're still scoring more points.
As long as they keep playing like this, as long as they have bales for their stacker and the stacker can just do what he does best, Horsch won't be able to catch up, basically. But JZD needs to just continuously put bales on the belt. If they stop, then there is a chance for Horsch, and I'm sure they know that, so they're gonna make sure that they have these points for the next 2 minutes. And that should be an easy win for JZD, as long as they keep doing what they do.
Yeah, JZD is a very, very good team, and they are 160 points higher in circuit points than Horsch currently. So, we kind of expect JZD to probably obliterate them, but we have seen in previous games before where the other team that's not as good in terms of circuit points has beat them, so we may get to see that.
This can't happen. This is exactly what can't happen. If you are behind, you can't have these mistakes. You can't have bales not going on.
Yeah, that's just bad.
That's just super bad. And yeah, JCD, I mean, they are a wildcard team. We should maybe mention that. So this league does have seeded teams, which basically means that there are sponsored teams by the manufacturers. Horsch obviously being one of them.
Yep.
You know, there are more like Krone that we're going to see, Amazon that we're hopefully going to see today. John Deere, Class, all these teams. JCD, they don't have a sponsor. They are not doing this. They are just here on their own. They are three friends deciding they're going to play the game. They started playing it. They started rocking it. They won a lot. And now they are here in the World Championships playing for the 100 grand.
Yeah.
So,
I mean, whatever the case, I think that's great. I mean, JCD, they've managed to get here right to the end, to the stage where they're going to be qualifying to get right into the end. I mean, it's pretty awesome that they've managed to be able to do it. Whoever wins or loses any of these matches today and last week and next week as well, to get to this stage in FSL is a pretty big accomplishment.
Oh, that one's nice. Oh, I bet it didn't
work. The bales dropped.
Sorry, Hyper. Nice try, though. But yeah, they know they've won that one, so they're taking it easy. 15 seconds to go. 250 points lead.
It looks like it's going to be JZD. JZD is going to win this, everyone.
Yeah, so that's 1-0 for JZD. Doesn't mean it's over, though. Horsch just needs to come back because it's a best of three, as we mentioned before. So we're gonna have a second game, but GG JCT doing what we expected them to do and just dominating that group basically.
Yeah, big congrats to JCT. There we go. Yeah, they did a really good job, and we kind of did expect that. We did kind of expect that. So what do you think the next match will be like? Do you reckon they'll win that again?
I think we're gonna see pretty much the same. I don't think Horsch has it to beat JCT. I really don't. I think they have a better chance beating Krone, because Krone, while they were one of the most dominating teams in the league, they were choking a bit lately. So, and we don't know what to expect from Krone, right? If Krone is back to their old form, they will easily win that.
Yep.
But if they don't, I don't know. So I totally expect JCT to do the exact same thing, win again, and then we're going to have Krone versus JCT for group win, basically. And then afterwards, the loser of them,
the loser match
will happen with Amazon, and that is when we need to know if Amazon is back. Basically. They have like 30 minutes left, otherwise they are out.
Yeah, and essentially, if we get into the losers match and Amazon haven't managed to fix their internet connections and problems like that, then essentially Horsch or whoever loses in this next part, they will be essentially winning. So I suppose that's a pro for them. But
exactly. The way that works, if everything stays as it is right now, the way that works is JCT will most likely win that one. Horsch goes to the loser bracket and instantly wins because Amazon is not there.
Yeah, so, and people are saying in chat again, this is not us. These are the German casters on your screen right now. These are in Germany currently. I am in the UK, and Lars, he is in Germany as well. We're the English commentators. So
it would just be super weird to have me alone in the studio. So it's just the Germans on screen. Yeah. We are not on screen, but you can hear us. So
yeah,
it's just what it is. It seems to be a little bit weird, and I know it's weird because the sound seems to be off, but that's just because that's the German screen.
Yep. And the new thing in the bottom right as well, that's showing us the in-game look right now. You can see the game, the team's just connecting. There's three over there on Horsch connected currently, and two on JZD. So
yeah,
two players. So I guess we'll see the other one pop on in just a second.
Yeah, most likely. And then we have, again, like a minute left before the game starts, once they are all in the lobby. Because the tech team, of course, in the background will make sure the server is stable, everything is fine, and then starts the game. It's like roughly a minute. Can be 10 seconds longer or 10 seconds less. But yeah, we are pretty much a minute away from the game. Unless there is another connection problem. That would be nightmare right now for Jason. No, there he is. All good.
Yep, there he is.
Just imagine JCT couldn't connect. That would be just the worst.
Yeah, I'm just looking at some of the stats for Horsch. It says here that they lost at the Gamescom final versus Trailbog.
Yeah,
so yeah. So that's they managed to do Gamescom with Trailbog. That was pretty cool. It also says they was the first seeded team of the league as well for the FSL. So a few little stats there for people. And
some people might remember that Horsch was where we had FarmCon. Was it 17? No, that was 18. FarmCon 18. Ever since, we have a very, very good relationship to Horsch. And when we started talking about the league, they were the first one to going, oh, nice, we're going to have a Horsch team. That basically kicked it off.
Yep. And we also, for JZD as well, which is the other team competing right now, they missed the top four of the circuit points by 10 points. So, that must have... it just shows, though, they are a very good team. So, very, very good. It says the strongest wildcard team of the FSL. So, they're a very, very good team. Anyway, we're jumping back in the game. Here we go, here's the teams.
And I'm sure we're going to see JCT next season as well. I'm just not sure we're going to see them as a wildcard team. Because if there is a sponsor out there, they will most likely, they made the name for themselves. I don't see JCT being a wildcard team next season.
They're very good.
I totally see a sponsor picking them up.
Yeah, they are very, they're good. They're up there and they're a very good team. So that is, a good chance. Anyway, they're picking the tractors. The Fendt 1050 just there. The Massey Ferguson telehandler. That's been banned. What's this? The JCB? No, the Slayer.
I just see Techers asking, why did the last team lose? So there are a couple of things that Horsch was just slower. Looking at it from it's always easier to talk about it when the game is already over. But you should have seen that JCT was always a little step ahead. They had the plan to get the grain boost from the beginning. So while Horsch was scattered, JCT was there ready for the drone. And they picked the drone drop as soon as it dropped. So they made sure they get what they want. And because they got what they want, they were already in position to execute on it. Like, the grain was already ready. They picked up the drop, used the grain, drove it to the silo, increased the multiplier right away. So it was just, they were like 30 seconds faster than Horsch in every single thing they did. You're right, we didn't go over that during the action. Sorry.
With everything they did in the previous round, I mean, there was just ahead of them with everything they did. I think they won by like 600 or something points just then. So compared to the other team, which was like a few hundred points behind them. So everything they did in the previous round was, it was behind them. So we'll see, maybe they'll be able to catch up in this next round. Yeah. They're currently picking the power plays. Chiptuning.
It's a fair point. So the thing is, we always have to guess what's happening next.
Yep.
When we don't know, when we see they do something, we can guess why they do it, but we don't know for sure until we see it executed. But we can totally play a little bit of a guessing game, especially for newer players, because it might be obvious for people who watch this for months and know exactly why a team does that. But for you guys, newer guys, we try to do better.
I just want to say as well, one of the power plays that we just picked then was the under pressure, which we don't see that too much. That is press the bales faster. So it seems like they're changing the tactics up a little bit just here.
Yeah, they did that last run as well. So the first thing first, we're going to explain that very quick again. There are 8 pots down there, 4 balers and 4 harvesters on it, and they are mirrored. And what's on what pot is random every game. But if on the very right pot is the John Deere harvester for your team, it's always also there for the other team. The first thing you do is grab as much as you can, pull it off the pot. If you pull something off the pot, you see the green lights. They attach it, it's yellow. And as soon as they drive down, the lights are off. And for the other team, they turn red. That means you can't pick it anymore.
Yeah, you can see the chrome baler. You can see the coon baler just here. This is Mr. Marcel's, I think. He is going to connect to it. Now he's picked it, it's yellow. And then when it comes off, you can see just there. Boom, it goes. Yeah. It goes.
They also have defend. So it is fair again. 2 harvesters on the side of JCD and 2 harvesters on the side of Horsch. And you can see JCD already on the field. The ideal is already harvesting. Same for Horsch. They have the New Holland already on the field.
And they're already going around the field. Different teams as well harvest the fields differently. Some teams go straight to the Ogre Trailer. Some teams go around the field as well. Just different methods. I guess every team has their own different ways, right?
Yeah, the way Horsch does it usually, if they have 2 harvesters like they do now, is they have one starting in the middle to free the Horsch Ogre Wagon.
Yeah, and the other one goes
make sure they can put it, and the other one harvests as close as possible to the barn so that they can press bales and bring them over to score more points. For JCD, they both start in the middle, and then they usually just split, one going to the left, one going to the right. But for Horsch, we can see it here, right? The John Deere is in the middle, and the other one was just somewhere very far away. You can see the New Holland in the very back. Driving around there. So.
Yeah, I mean, it isn't just driving the combines and harvesting. There is a method to how they drive and harvest. Each combine driver, you can see, they're all doing different things. Somebody starts in the middle, somebody starts at the end. Some teams start 2 combines in the middle, some start, you know, not. And so every team has their own way, and depending on what they do, obviously, that is what benefits them. So, yes.
Absolutely. And for Horsch, this is super important, because as we said last match, they were doing okay. They were just slower in everything they did than JCD.
Yeah.
And trying to mix it up a bit and making it faster, that should help. Mr. Marcel here with the fan press, that helps as well, because it's the fastest press in the game.
And they also have the press bales faster as well. That's one of the power plays. They did pick that in the previous round as well. But the reason we're talking about the power plays is last week, most teams last week actually picked the same power plays. So it's pretty cool that this week they're picking different ones. It's that is quite nice to see.
Yeah, well, right now, chip tuning and slide edge are just meter. Every team, well, pretty much every team picks these two up. The reason for that is because it makes you so fast that you can pick up the harvesters and everything from the pots faster than the opposing team, so you get what you want. And this is a huge advantage, obviously. However, with under pressure, it helps you on the field, especially if you have the fend and maybe the crone press. That would be awesome, didn't get the crone press. It just helps a lot during the entire game. So there's a reason.
Yeah, you can press the bales so much faster. You can also see as well, Horsch are currently at 40 points. They have managed to get one of the do one of the first bales. They've sold one of the first bales already. They've hit the points with that. And this is Team Horsch. And they just open up the Ogre Trail just there. They haven't pulled it out of the field. They've just opened the lid up in case the combines need to unload.
They just tried to make everything faster. The Ogre Wagon is already ready. They're going to start unloading soon. So,
we have a note from the ref. It says Amazon won't make it to the losers match. So up next is the winners match. Crone versus JCD versus Horsch. Ah, yeah, okay. So
That also means whoever loses this match automatically won the next one.
Yep.
The way that the tournament system works right now, the group system works, is it's a double elimination. You have to lose twice to be out of the tournament. You have to win twice to be in the final eight. So for this game, it's JCT versus Horsch. And whoever wins that one, for the moment, let's just pretend it's JCT. That would mean that Horsch goes to the loser bracket. That's where Amazon waits. But Amazon can't connect. They can't make it. So Horsch would win that one and make it to the loser finals. JCT would proceed to go to the winner finals and play Krone, because they won against Amazon without even playing. And then you have Krone versus JCT. And again, the winner would be the group leader, done, playing against John Deere in the final eight. And the second one, or the loser, would go to the loser final and play for the second seed against whoever wins against Amazon next.
Yeah, so yeah, a little
bit. It'll make more sense with a graphic. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's a little bit of a shame there for Amazon. Amazon can't join. Yeah, bad luck, I guess. Yeah, so they've lost for today. Not great. What's going on?
This is super sad because it's a fantastic team. Lovely people.
And yeah,
it's
they
just
are
sad to get kicked out of the world championship and basically end your season. Because that's it, right?
I mean, the thing is, they've managed to be able to get this far in FSL, and now today, the very moment they need to get into the qualifiers, they can't connect. I mean, that is it's not good.
they must be pretty upset.
Yeah.
However, they had a good run. They had a good season. I hope we see them again next season.
Yeah, I'm sure they'll be back.
Want to mention it again because it's so special. Amazone, they are a very special team in the FSL. First of all, everyone who plays for Amazone works for Amazone.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
It's
they actually work for them.
It is a real Amazone team. There are no player transfers. Like, for example, Horsch has a couple of guys that they just picked up because they are fantastic players, and same for John Deere. It's not everyone works at John Deere just because they play for them. For Amazone, they do.
Yeah.
And the other thing that's so cool about Amazone is because it's all employees, the company said, look, if our guys win, we take whatever they won, the prize money. Well, we basically match that and donate it to charity because we don't
really
need
good.
That money. Everything our team wins, of course, the team can keep it. Like if the team, this because they are out now, I think they won. I'm not even sure if you are out top 16. I think it's $1,500 or something you still make.
Yeah.
Amazon will take that money and give it, donate it to charity, while the players can, of course, keep it for themselves because they won. So that's super nice. And I think it's the only team we have that does that, that donates everything they win to charity. And I love that. So I'm a big Amazon fan, not gonna lie. I'm a big fan. So I'm
They're a really, really cool team. Somebody in chat says, is there any prizes? Yes, there is going to be a big prize. It's 100,000, right?
It's 100,000 cash plus. Yeah. There is, of course, hardware from our sponsors, Logitech and Nitrado.
And also Cortiva as well. They're one of the sponsors.
Cortiva are the ones, basically. That's the main sponsor. That's our main sponsor. They are making sure that there is this high cash prizes. It's $250,000 in total over the course of the season, this being the final of the season.
Yeah, I believe they'll be winning the 100k in September next month once all the qualifiers are through. So
I mean, it is distributed over all the teams. So the higher you come, the more of the 100k you get. It's not that, you know, you get 100k or nothing.
No,
that's not how it works. and there's the drone drop.
Here we go. So they're gonna get the wheat value by the looks of things.
Again,
there we go.
Yes.
Boom.
Grain boost again.
Grain boost.
Picked up by JZD. They really love that one. And the question now is Horsch faster? Because you can see JCD, the auger wagon is just standing there. They're not doing anything with it. But what about Horsch? Are they doing anything?
Yeah,
no, they don't.
Oh, interesting. Yeah, so you can see just there. This is Team Horsch, and they're currently unloading into the auger trailer. What they're going to do now, because we have the grain boost, they're going to get into the Puma. Yeah, just now you can see they're getting into the Puma, the Case Puma, and they're going to drive over as fast as they can to the unload point and start unloading their grain. We also have the other team just here. This is JZD. And, I mean, the points are still pretty low. I mean, Horsch are at 60 points, JZD are at zero. But we will definitely start seeing that go up any minute now once this multiplier starts going into the unload point.
Absolutely. And Horsch is faster right now. It's like, it's a different approach. It's basically the same game we've seen before with JZD picking up the grain boost. But Horsch is prepared for it right now. So they are not like a minute behind. Because last time we've seen this multiplier going up to 2.9 and 1.1 before Horsch even started to drive in that direction. And this time it should be faster.
Yeah, it definitely seems like the higher this time they're going faster and they're in the same sort of time range as the other team. So you can see, so, just here, everyone, this is the multiplier. It's currently going up, and it's going up in JZD's favor. Now it's going back down.
Is, the oh, question is, will it stick at like 2.3 again for JZD or not? Because that is what broke the neck of Horsch last time. They didn't have enough grain, and they might not this time because it doesn't look too good.
Oh, 2.2, 2.1.
Maybe they get it back to...
Yeah.
So close. So close. And now they start picking up bales and scoring.
Yeah, so this is when we're going to start seeing all the bales getting piled on everyone. I see loads of bales just lined up there. That was for team JZD. JZD has a lot of bales lined up. They are ready for this.
Yeah, they're super ready.
Yeah, they're ready. And Horsch just there. They don't have too many bales. You can see there's a few more coming off just now from the Fendt baler. But they don't have too many here. The other team do have quite a lot.
I see people going, I'll assemble a team. How do I join? You go to fsl.giants-software.com. Sign up with your team, sign up for the tournaments. Of course, there is no tournament to be had right now because this is the World Championship.
Yep.
And this marks the end of the season.
But you could join for next year. I mean, you could practice.
But yeah, we're going to have a new season soon. And then you can totally join in and play. And everyone can join, everyone can play. And if you win, you get prizes. And if you make it to the top 16 by the end of the year, you can go to the World Championship and play exactly what they do. Maybe not at home, maybe in our sports studio in Germany. But yeah, that really depends on that pandemic out there.
Yeah, I mean, the cool thing is anybody can win. Anybody, you know, even the public, some of the players just now, you guys who are in chat. If you get a team and you get a really good team and you, you know, put the work in to become good, you can actually get there and join this next year. So yeah, you should definitely think about that if you're interested.
Yeah. So and we haven't announced any prizes for next season. This season, it's because I saw someone asking, this season it was a $250,000 in total. With 100 grand in cash just for the World Championships, and as we said, there are also hardware prizes sponsored by Logitech and Nitrado. Yep. They are on top of it, so
I'm sure we'll
you won't be a millionaire after playing it. It is decent money. You can still buy a car though.
Yeah, you could put it into Amazon stock or something.
Or that, and then be a millionaire later. That could work.
Yeah.
Oh. So anyway, Horsch needs to get points on. They're 100 points behind. It's way better than the last
cool thing
game.
Is, yeah, this is what I'm saying right now. 3 minute 50, and both teams are very close in terms of scores. 336 just here to JZD, and 231, very close with the scores right now. I think it helps because the multiplier isn't too much in Horsch's disadvantage right now. It is in their disadvantage a little bit, but it's not as much as the previous round. So that is definitely helping them out. It's going to be a closer round, I think. It's going to be much closer.
Absolutely. It all comes down to execution now. It's 3 minutes left. Horsch is... Oh!
Wow.
Yeah, well, you can do that with a tractor. Don't do it in real life, though.
That was pretty cool.
That was nice.
That has to be a replay later on. That's awesome.
Yeah, that will be a replay, I bet.
Oh, wow.
And you can see that JCT, they're running out of bales. So for Horsch, they need to constantly get in bales now. They totally have a chance. It's just 100 points. It's not too bad right now, so they absolutely adjusted their play, but they can't make any mistake. Like that one bale there, I'm sure it is not supposed to be there like this.
No, it has to be. It needs to be picked up and turned around. The thing is, they can't just pick that up and put it on. They need to pick it up, tidy it up, and get it straight, and then put it on, right?
Yeah. So otherwise, it will just fall down again, and you lose another 30 seconds.
Yeah, I think they're kind of focusing on the bales that they can just pick up right now, and then they'll come to that one after, if there's no more bales there.
Yeah. And JCD, because... they have no bales anymore. Their bale stackers, they are just back on the fields on their own, basically, without the baler just picking up bales and delivering them, because they do have the time. And this is actually a mistake. If your stacker has time to drive back and get something from the field, that means that there are no bales that he can use. That costs time. We see that a lot, though. A lot of teams have their stacker just going and grabbing bales, but it's just better if he doesn't have to. If he gets delivered bales constantly, he's in a way better position to score points while the other team drives around.
I think that bale's going to drop off. See that? Watch this bale. It's going to drop.
Yeah, won't make it.
There we go.
And that brings us back to this can't happen. Like, no, if you want to win this, you are 100 points behind. These bales need to get in.
Yeah, they need to get in. Somebody in chat is asking whether the other team can steal each other's bales. No, each team they have their own section. You can see there's a barrier in between both fields just here. Each team, they cannot get into the other team's area. The only thing they can do to manipulate the other team's scores and things like that is the unload points. You can obviously do that with the multiplier. So that's the only thing they can do, really. It's with the conveyor
belts. And the bridges, of course.
Oh, yes,
so
the bridges.
There are ways to basically tamper with the opposing team's possibility to score points, but not by attacking them. This is not an attacking game. This is harvesting.
quite a relaxed game.
This is peaceful.
It's relaxed, but it is quite intense. A lot of people do quite enjoy it. I see everyone in chat, they're really enjoying it.
Yeah, it is. We call it esports for everyone because it is a very, very calm, relaxing esport, but it's still very competitive. And depending on who plays, sometimes it is a nail biter. Sometimes, to be fair, it's not. Yeah. But then again, if you see Real Madrid playing against some random team, it's not a nail biter either.
So yeah, when you see the top teams competing, I mean, what I'm looking forward to is next month, right at the end, all the top teams are going to be competing against each other. Right? I mean, it's just going to be so intense because all the top teams are going to be so good at it. I mean, it's just going to be really cool to see.
We've got another bridge. I'm really looking forward to. It looks like it will be JCD versus Krona as well because we haven't seen Krona today. They won by Amazon not making it, and Krona hit or miss, absolutely hit or miss team. They won tournaments. They finished second. They played awesome. They also had tournaments where they were just
Krona were a really good team as well.
Being there, so
yeah,
it can be super interesting or not.
See we're 5 seconds out and 630. Looks like JZD has won again. So that means there will not be a third match with this opening match.
GG awesome JZD making it to the winners' finals. And so, now JZD, it's easier for me to explain what's going to happen now.
I mean, Hush, they was up there just then. They obviously wasn't lagging behind. They was quite close there in points. So yeah, big congrats to them.
It was way better, but they were still a little bit behind when it comes to everything. So the way that works now is Krona versus JCD will be the next match. Whoever wins that one wins the group and moves to the quarterfinals in September. Whoever loses that one will play against Horsch because Horsch has an automatic win against Amazon and now in the loser bracket. So we're going to see two more games. The first one will be Krona versus JCD. Winner is group first. The loser will play against Horsch and the winner of that match will finish second and face the Burning Gamers by Stark in the top eight. And then we are done. And next week, by the way, is the what I consider to be the group of death. Next week is with four teams that are super close. close.
Yeah, they're pretty close. Yeah, we do have another one next week, everyone who's in the chat. So definitely tune in for that. Looking forward to that. This tournament today is not going to be going on for too long just because of Amazon. They obviously can't connect to the servers or anything. They're having some internet problems. So that's why we're skipping a few matches today, and it's going straight to for a win. Yeah. I'm ready to play now. Put me in the game now. I came here to prove it. I'm ready to do it. I can't be afraid now. Put me on the stage now. I'm ready to rage now. I feel like an animal stuck in a cage and I'm ready to break out. So what are you afraid of? Those feelings are made of. Get in the game, your moment of fame. Show them what you made of. It's time that we stand up. It's time that we man up. For anyone asking who is the best, we putting our hands up. My time, my time. None of you people can tell me to stop. This time, like the last time, you better get ready to race in the top. I'm ready to do this, show you what the truth is. I step on the field, it's time to get real. I'm feeling so ruthless. My time, my time. None of you people can tell me to stop. Lower the lights down. Hand over my crown. Hand over my heart. I do this for my town. I do this for my crowd. So turn me up real loud. My time. We're back.
Yeah, that was that was quick. I was like, oh, we should be back.
And then it cut off as well. We didn't see the time going down. Next up, everyone, we have Corona versus JDZ. We would usually be having the losers match next, but we're not because of obviously Amazon not being able to connect. So next up, it's going to be Corona and JDZ. Them two going to be competing. Two very, very good teams. They're very, very good. So we may get to see three rounds with these two. I guess we'll see.
I hope so. Yeah. I would love to see a best of three that goes over three rounds this time.
Yeah, this would be really cool to see this next round. I think we might get some replays as well in a few minutes, few seconds or so. We saw some in the last round. We saw some pretty cool shots of the there was flying over the bridge, like there was driving straight up it, went straight up into the air with the New Holland. It was that was pretty awesome to see. And we obviously JZD won against Horse. So yeah,
and this is a good chance to mention again that we are not the guys on screen.
Oh no, here we go again.
There we go, replays.
We always have to remember that.
This is Mr. Marcel. And this is what we're talking about with Horsch being slow.
Yeah, look at this.
This is like 20 seconds lost for one of your players.
About.
Because
what is he doing?
He's just driving around.
He's just driving into the bales. What is he doing? that wasn't good from Mr. Marcel then.
And that's how you lose 30 seconds, and that's how you lose the game in the end, because you really need that time. You can't just have one guy driving over bale presses for like 20 seconds.
Yeah, every second is so important, and he was just messing about. I don't know what was going on there. He got stuck on the bales. What have we got next? I guess we'll see another replay. I'm looking at this next round is going to be pretty cool. I'm really looking forward to this next round. Crone is actually I think they're third in circuit points.
Yes.
So they are definitely one of the top teams. I think it goes Trelborg, and then it goes the other team under it. I believe what's the team underneath Trelborg? John Deere, and then it goes Crone.
Yeah.
So they're the top three.
And then it's the Landeyer. Yeah. Yeah, that's the top four. I wonder if this has become a meme on chat, or if people are still wondering why
that was pretty cool.
Flying New Holland, no problem at all.
Yeah, I think people might just be trolling us now with the audio.
Yeah, we still stick to it and still mention, because there are a lot of people coming in, that these guys, there are Sachsen Lex Slayer on the left and Humor on the right. These are the German commentators over on Giant Software. DE is the German stream. We are at home due to Corona. We couldn't fly Joe in, so he has to sit at home in his comfortable home and just do it from there. And so do I.
Yes, indeed. You can see in the bottom right just there, we have the teams joining. These are Team Crone and JZD. This is actually a new feature. I was talking about this earlier on. This is a new feature just there in the bottom right. We can actually see the teams connecting now, so it doesn't just switch over all of a sudden and we get shots.
And here we see it again, right? English commentary, Lars and Joe. I'm Lars, he's Joe. And these two guys are not us. Yeah, maybe we need to have that on screen longer.
Yeah, maybe so. We could maybe have something where it sort of like a moving sort of bubble or something showing that we're speaking, the English casters. I don't know. Maybe looking something like that. That'd be pretty cool.
Just have two comic tunes somewhere on the screen, you know? we are these two comic guys there.
Yeah.
The cat and the dog or something.
Oh. Oh, wow.
So, yeah. That's where we are. These are the Germans one. They are in the new build sports studio we built for the FSL in Erlangen. Obviously being the commentator's desk. We're going to show the rest of the studio during the World Championships in September, because that's where they are held. And our tech is just like, okay, we need to show this more often. We do. Thank you, tech. I love it.
It's really cool. I mean, that TV behind him just there, I mean, that looks awesome, that screen, with all the moving parts just there on it.
Yeah,
it's pretty awesome. And the studio is really good as well.
Yeah, it will most likely look a little bit different during the World Championship, because we are still rearranging the studio a bit. So it's not the absolute final setup. It might look a little bit more impressive or less impressive. No, it will look more impressive in September. And if you don't have anything to do right there, and if you do have anything to do, change your plans and be there for the World Championship Final Eights, September 19 and 20. That's a full weekend of FSL action. And at the end of it, we're going to have a world champion. And you don't want to miss that. You really
don't. That's going to be really cool. And it's going to be the top teams as well. So it's going to be so much action. It's going to be, it's just going to be so competitive. It's going to be awesome. I just want to say as well, with all these group stages, we could have actually been done with all this. FAMCON that took place a few weeks ago. That could have been the final. That could have been the FSL final. But because of the current situations with the world, we're not going to get into that or anything. But because of that, that's why we're having these group stages now. So
exactly.
Yeah. So some people might have been thinking, how come it's changed and it didn't? You know, it wasn't at FSL. It wasn't at FAMCON. That's why we have the group stages now.
Exactly. And now, as we said, it's the Group C finals. It will take a while. They are still preparing. Maybe we can talk about the teams very quick. We've spoken about JCD a lot.
Yeah, definitely.
But let's talk about Krone. Krone actually is the Creative Mesh team, right? If you guys play our game, you know Creative Mesh from the Straw Harvest add-on.
Yeah, they make the Straw Harvest.
And the players, these are the guys who created that one. So basically a Krone Baylor that's in the FSL, they made it. Like, it's theirs. They build it for us.
And what's cool as well is they are in Creative Mesh. They managed to do the FSL and work on the Straw Harvest DLC at the same time. I mean, it's so much work. It's pretty good that they managed to be able to do that.
Absolutely.
So yeah, it's really cool of them. Krone are the third as well on this in circuit points.
Yes.
So they're under. It goes Trelleborg number one, John Deere, and then it goes Krone. So yeah, they're definitely up there. One of the best teams.
So they're basically the group lead of Group C. So we expect them to put up a very good fight. It will be a close game against JCD. And I saw people asking, "Are you on TwitchCon?" Well, let's talk about the journey we had. We started at FarmCon, which is our very own con last year. We have ever since been to Gamescom and played there. We have been to Paris Games Week. We have been to the Poznan Game Arena. We have played at DreamHack in Leipzig. We have been on the Intel Extreme Masters in Katowice.
Agritechnica?
We are everywhere. Agritechnica, everywhere. Of course. But these guys seem to be into esports. So let me tell you, this is played at the Intel Extreme Masters, dude. This is a big deal, okay? This is actual farming simulator esports. It's not us making fun of anything. It's a quarter million in prizes. This is a proper league with sponsored teams. We have sponsors. We have professional teams from John Deere, Klaas, Horsch, Amazone, Trelleborg, Krone, and many, many more. This is a proper league with proper people, proper teams, proper events, proper everything. And due to Corona, it's a bit online right now. But yeah
and FSL also goes all over Europe as well. I mean, they go to Germany, they go to Switzerland, Poland, France. I mean, it's just crazy. Like, you guys have been everywhere, right? It's
definitely... And just yesterday, there was a tournament in Australia. We shouldn't forget that. It wasn't part of the league.
Okay.
But we had our first farming simulator esports. So it's not farming simulator league. But it's Farming Simulator Esports Tournament in Australia. It happened for us yesterday, so
that's
2 days
cool.
ago for the Australians, I guess. Wow. But we are everywhere, dude. Everywhere. Yeah. We do have a team from South Africa. They're actually watching.
Really?
Yeah. I've seen them in the chat. Hello, guys. Nice that you guys are
hello
here.
From, hello, South Africans.
Year.
Welcome to the stream. we may get to see them in season two, right? In season three, next year.
They did well in season two. They didn't make it to Final 16, but they were a good team. They need a little bit more practice, and then who knows?
Yeah.
So
I'm not quite sure what's going on the screen right now. We'd usually be in the game now watching the teams getting ready. But it seems like the camera's gone off at the bottom right. I guess
there might be an issue with the servers or something. Tech hasn't said anything.
There we go. Sweet.
I was about to say Tech hasn't said anything, so it can't be a big deal. And in that very second, they were like, okay, let's start then.
As soon as we start talking about it, it pops up.
Because we do have a direct connection, of course, to the tech team. We have a very big tech team with observers and, of course, referees and everything right there. And we get everything we need to know from them.
Yeah.
If there is radio silence like now, then we know everything is fine and we're going to see the next thing.
Yeah, and when we go to these tournaments and things, when we go to Gamescom, Agritechnica, to Zurich, all these other types of cool gaming events. There's a massive stage, right? With loads of lights. It's a massive, well-built stage. It's really, really cool.
Yeah, we need two full trucks to transport it through Europe.
Two
and
massive,
we do have to. If you see a Farming Simulator League truck out there, it's us preparing the next tournament. And Weatherman, I was talking about you. Hello to South Africa. And nice to hear that the South African tournament is about to start.
Yeah,
so
that's really cool.
They are doing a South African tournament, and we should know more about that in the very near future. We are everywhere.
Pretty cool.
Absolutely, yes. So again, the teams are getting ready. You can see it on the bottom right screen.
Oh,
there we go.
Go
winners
so
finals, Krone versus Jason.
Now, these two teams are really good. Krone, like we said, they're the top three. They're the third right now in circuit points. JCD, they're up there as well. They're a very good team. So we're expecting these two teams to be very close to each other today. And it could actually go into three matches. It's going to be the best of three. If one team wins twice, then obviously they win. But it could potentially be a best of three this next round. They're definitely very good.
And we haven't seen Blackjack in a while. The team captain for Krone, I think he was busy during the last one or two tournaments, or it might be super mistaken, but I'm quite sure Blackjack wasn't there all the time. It's nice to see him back, so Krone with Ale Dude, Blackjack, and Str, STR, yeah. Back on the field. So they have a very good setup. They play with what I would consider the best team they can have for Krone. So it will be very interesting. And they decided just not to ban a second vehicle.
Oh, wow. So we don't need to ban anything. So we don't usually get to see that. That doesn't happen too much. That's fairly rare. They haven't actually picked a tractor. You can see just there, they completely missed it. They haven't picked one.
Maybe the they didn't want to, because if you ban out narrow tires with the Steyr gun, there's only one left. If you ban out one of the big ones, there's only one left. And they knew they couldn't pick first, so maybe it was a tactic.
Yeah, I mean, they've banned the JCB, the Telehandler, the Massey Fuggs, and also the Steyr as well. And now we're currently picking the vehicles. You can see we have 45 seconds left, and they're just going through all the vehicles. We have the big Deutsch 1050 just there. That was actually banned in the previous match. Yes. You also have the Deutsch just there with a big massive weight on the front, and you have some front loaders as well.
I expect the Valtra to come in for Krone.
There we
and
go.
Here it is. It is the Valtra.
So yeah, you can see both teams, they do have front loaders with the bales, so they can definitely pick the bales up and take them over to the to score the points to the ban.
Yeah. And now we will probably see place. Chip tuning slide edge. Yeah, do you think one of them will pick something else? I think it will be chip.
We did see that in the previous round, but it's usually they usually pick the same things. That usually happens more so. You can see chip tuning's been picked and slight edge is currently being picked by JZD. Yes, there we go. So yeah, both teams have got the same.
So in case you're wondering what these things do, these power plays affect your entire team, everything that happens. Chip tuning makes your tractors, and I hope I pronounce this correctly, accelerate faster.
Yep.
So you and are just edge. getting and off and yeah.
Yeah, and slight edge, that obviously, that increases the top speed of the vehicle. So a lot of the teams, they do really focus on trying to get the speed of these things much faster.
You want to be as fast as possible.
Yeah, so these teams... see the 1050 just there is then over to the Chrome Baylor. Yeah.
These teams didn't know what's where because, as we said, on these pods, everything is random. So they have like 10 seconds to make sure they know where they want to go, and they just did that. We can see Krone has two harvesters already. There is the John Deere for JCD and the Ideal. Has anyone picked up the Ideal just yet?
No. It doesn't look like it. It looks like it's still green.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, interesting. And the Ideal Combine, that is a pretty important combine to have. It has a massive grain tank.
For Krone, they did have the Krone JCD picked up three
presses. We have a bale streak.
What happened to the Ideal? Okay, JCD got it. So... Two harvesters, three balers for JCD.
Yeah, so because we have a bale, so for people wondering, a bale streak essentially means that one of the teams has three bales, which is a pretty big advantage for that team, really. It means they can produce lots more bales. So JCD, they are definitely off to a pretty good start right now.
Absolutely are. The good news for Krone is that they got basically their own press, the Krone press. That one can store three bales at once. So it's not too big of a disadvantage if you have that one. However, if it's all about, you know, that last bale going in the very last seconds, then it definitely is advantage JCD right now. And we have to see how it turns out.
Yeah.
For the next 5 minutes, we're going to see what we call the preparation phase. Teams are just getting ready for the drone drops. So they bring in bales, make sure that they are ready to get stacked. They fill up the horse, making sure that the horse is ready to deliver grain when the drone drop happens. So the game is a bit slow in the first 5 minutes because it's preparation.
This is usually like the calmest part of the game. This is usually like when the teams are just preparing things, they're getting the harvesting done. They're also baling in the fields as well. And this is just the calmest part. We don't really usually see too much crazy action taking place here at this point. It usually starts taking place under the 10-minute mark. That's usually when we start seeing things really starting to get hot.
Absolutely. But it also is the most important part because
if
your preparation goes wrong, you won't be able to score the points when it's needed. So you need to focus on getting a good preparation right now. For example, that means getting the first bale,
look at that just there. The bale went
thrown
flying.
To wherever the hell you want instead of on the conveyor belt. That's bad. And, you know, getting the bales ready. You can tell that, and you will see that very often, that these bales are just left and right of the conveyor belt, like a little bit like this, not entirely straight, but a little bit to the side. So that as soon as you start picking up these bales to score points, you are super fun. Oh, that was nicely done. Very smooth.
Hypo just absolutely rammed into the conveyor belt just then, and then the bale went flying. I don't think he expected that to happen. And now he's out to obviously go pick the bale up and put it on the conveyor. But he's managed to get it in. He's got 40 points.
And we don't know. We have seen it in week one when Trelleborg played OEG and OEG wanted to score the first bale and they put it on the conveyor, but we've seen Lucas just ramming that belt, throwing that bale in, but it was still like half a second too slow. But that was super impressive. Maybe it was a try to copy that.
Yeah, maybe it was. Yeah. I mean, there's loads of different types of techniques that these teams can do. One of them is obviously if you have a telehandler, you can obviously reach higher up on the conveyor belt. So that does give you an advantage with the telehandler. So yeah, some teams like to do that if they have a telehandler. Right now, we're at 11:30, 40 points right now for JZD. And you can see we have the real fast baler just there, the fence. That obviously produces the bales pretty fast.
That doesn't look good. Usually, if you have the crone, what you try to do is you unload the first bale and then drive a big bit backwards and unload the second one on top of the first one so that you have them nicely stacked. It didn't work. Again, disadvantage will cost you a couple of seconds to fix this. Not good. But yeah, nothing happened so far. 11, yeah, I mean, the chrome, minutes, everything is still possible.
The chrome baler is actually quite, because it's so tall, it's quite a high baler. You can actually put a bale on top of another bale when you're unloading. So that a lot of teams do that to do that, but it does take a bit of work to be able to master. So obviously, sometimes we see it, sometimes we don't see it work, and just then, it obviously didn't work. So yeah, I'm sure we'll see it again in a few minutes, though.
Yeah,
I'm quite surprised actually that little New Holland tractor is pulling the massive chrome baler.
That little New Holland tractor is just amazing. It's one of the reasons why it is the most picked tractor in the entire game.
Yeah, I mean it's just
that's so good.
Yeah, it's like it's managing to pull that massive baler. It's crazy. And you can see just here, Hyper just taking the top off just there of the Ogre Trailer. That means is gonna essentially he's opening it up to allow the combines to start putting the grain in a few minutes time once it starts needing to be unloaded.
And I totally expect JCD to go with the same tactic they had before.
That's a nice view of the combine.
They go for grain boost again. And then
straight into the
bales. More bales. Nice. Yeah, you can tell these guys are practicing five times a week, right?
Yeah, these guys just never stop. They're awesome.
Krone getting ready as well. That because you obviously have to open the auger wagon, otherwise you can't unload. So this is done for both teams now, and I'm quite sure we're going to see them switching to one.
Yeah, we don't usually start seeing them, you know, putting the bales on the conveyor belt just yet. They usually wait until the grain boost has been taken, either the grain boost or the bale boost. When the drone drop takes place and the multiplier goes up, that's usually when we start seeing the bales going on the conveyor belt.
Exactly. Either way, you will get more points if that happens, right?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, that's
you don't
why
want to waste
sort of
your bales
right
because
now.
That will just make things worse. If you put them on now for like 20 points and then the bale boost happens and you would have gotten 30 for it, you wasted 10 points per bale. You don't want that, so you just prepare. That's why we call it a preparation phase. Just everyone in chat is like, just. Yeah, it's not that just. If you guys think this is the most easy esports game you've ever seen in your life, feel free to try your luck. It's super hard. It is super hard. They make it look easy, but that's just because they are professionals. Like,
yeah,
Messi makes football look easy.
Yeah, these teams are very, very good, everyone. So, and they've put so much action, so much time and energy into doing this over the whole year, you know, and also last year as well. This has been going on since when did it start? This the FSR it started early. I mean, it was early last year, right? It was,
July.
Yeah, July.
FarmCon last year was
July,
the first ever 28th. Tournament.
Yeah. So it's been going on this, everyone, since July 28th, 2019. So, these guys have definitely had a lot of time to be able to practice and get better and sort of tone their skills. So that's why we're getting... These are the best teams so far right now. This is why they're at the end and they're competing.
Yeah, this is the winner's finals. Whoever wins that one will face John Deere on September 19th in the top eight, in the quarterfinals. Whoever loses that one has to fight for their life against Horsch pretty much after this match. So, and that was just the power-ups dropping.
There we go.
There they
drops.
Are. And
what are they going to go for? The grain.
Taking the grain boost.
Yeah. So, what that means now is everyone, you can see the Deutz is already connecting up to the Ogre Trailer. He's going to take it there ASAP. And he's going to take, where's he going now? You can see all the combines are starting to unload. I don't think there's much grain in there.
That ideal is very full.
Yeah, it's like jam-packed. Oh, it seems like Krone's just there. They actually have a lot more grain already in the Ogre Trailer.
Yeah, and
they're already
on their
going.
Way.
Yeah, they're already going. And JZD, they are still filling up.
I'm quite sure Krone watched the first two matches, and they knew exactly what JZD is going to do.
I kind of think that JZD just here, they are actually going to have more in their Ogre Trailer just because of
30,700 compared to 29,300. So it's, it is more.
The ideal definitely holds a lot more. So
So it will end up with like 2.1 to 1.9 for JCB after everything is done, because there is still a minute left on the bale on the grain boost. So yeah, most likely 2.1 to 1.9, maybe 2.2 if they are lucky.
We'll know in literally just a few seconds time. You can see it ticking away back and forth, and it just sort of ticks away back and forth until it gets right to the end of the trailer. And once one of the team's trailers are completely unloaded, like in just about now,
Krone we'll takes where full advantage. This is beautiful. I mean, they know that in the end they might not have the higher multiplier, so they have bales on their conveyor belt right now. You can see they are up to 88 points because they are scoring points while they were at 2.4. And now that JCD is taking over, they actually scored these points already. So they have a couple of points in the bag.
Oh, they've just left the Auger Trail there.
Yeah, that means they are not going to unload again. They don't have to, though. They have an advantage.
I mean, we're at the 6 minute mark now. Obviously the drone drop has now been dropped. So everything now is just full on getting these bales to the barn and getting them on the conveyor. You can see already just this team here is JCD. They've already got tons of bales here. And there you go, that's the drone drop stopped. So,
and now they will start scoring points, and Krone needs to have bales ready. And this is exactly what we're talking about. They only have one bale press. So it will be hard for them to keep up with the bales that
this is,
come in.
This is the great thing about the baler streak, is one team has three bales. So they can have like, they can just like get loads of bales, and the other team has not as many. So, because they only have one baler, right? So yeah, we're going to see how that works out.
And I like how people are like, oh, these tractors are way too agile. Guys, these guys are alive, we got like 12 km/h. Come on. It's not Need for Speed here.
Yeah, just look how many bales are coming in now. This is absolutely crazy.
Yeah, that's one way to do it.
Just flip the bale over. And this is the Krone here, just here. Team Krone. Yeah. This is quite cool.
They actually, as well.
Yeah, they have quite a few bale stats on top of each other as well. You can see this team here, JZD, they don't. They just have them all over the place. They're quite close though, but they're not on top of each other. You can see Krone just here. They're stats. Not perfectly, but they are stacked pretty good.
They have 12 bales ready. That's not too bad. And the Krone is still out there. I'm quite sure that they're going to start stacking very soon. JCD, they are already doing it. And you can see how beautiful this guy is doing. Just when I said it. Thank you, Hyper, for nothing.
Oh, just when you said it, he dropped it. Oh, wow. STI just there, going over the bridge. Oh, no. Oh.
Works. All
you
good.
You've got to be so careful with that. You can tip up so easily.
Yeah, well, we have changed the way that... So this is the only bridge that you can't alter, right? It's fixed. So it's the only way to the barn if everything else goes wrong. And there has been a nerf to that lately, because there was a bump. That bump has been nerfed a bit, so it's a bit easier to drive over that bridge right now. But there is still a tiny bump. It still might lead to you just dropping there.
Yeah. So we are at three. Look, like, we can see right now just how many bales the advantage is right now. You can see JZD just here. They are at 313 points and Krone at 126. Krone needs to get these bales on the conveyor right now, ASAP.
They are playing this very well. STR is just stacking. A Blackjack is bringing in new bales so the Krone press can stay on the field. This is something that helps a lot because you only have one baler, right? You can see JZD, they are just driving with the balers. The New Holland is standing there, the Kuhn is used there, and I'm quite sure the Fendt is somewhere out there. They're just driving over, dropping bales, and starting again. For Krone, they are not doing this. They have their stacker at the barn, and they have one guy bringing in, you can see it here, Blackjack, bringing in the bales, and the Krone press is just on the field, constantly pressing. And this helps a lot, because you're never stopping to press bales, so one bale press, you're doing well.
Yeah, and like we were saying, Krone and JCD, they are two very good teams. Krone are there at the top. They're the third ones right now in the circuit points. Good points teams. So yeah, we could see this go either way. They're two very good teams. It's not like there's a massive disadvantage with one of the teams. So but this isn't good what's happening right now. You can see he's trying to pick this bale up and he keeps dropping it. He needs to get this bale on. That is you cannot afford to do that.
Right? I mean, this is your game to win, to make it to the World Championship Final 8.
Yeah,
so,
they might
be a bit nervous.
Yeah, for everyone in chat, this is big stuff right now. I mean, this is the qualifiers. This is what's going to get them into the, into the final for next month. I mean, all teams are going to be very nervous with this.
Absolutely are. And now for Krona, they are running out of bales. They need new ones. So I wonder where Blackjack is. Let's have a look at the minimap. Oh yeah, Blackjack is just arriving. You can see it somewhere. He should come into the screen in a few seconds.
Yeah, there he is. Sweet. And we have three bales.
They've delivered the Krone. So
yeah, they've actually put the Krone back. Oh.
Close
two bales.
2 minutes left.
Are these like the only two bales that the JZD has? I think it is. That's why we're looking at them. I think we're investigating, see how they're made.
Yeah. And you can see, Krona is just constantly delivering bales, making sure STR is just constantly getting bales up that that conveyor belt. And this is what you need to do right now. If you are Krona, you don't want STR to run out of bales, because as long as this guy has bales, you can totally make up for the points you are behind.
And the other reason...
Is JCD doing?
I have no idea. The reason JZD as well are actually getting more points at the moment than them is obviously they're bringing in a few more bales, but also the multiplier is obviously in their advantage and in Krone's disadvantage. You can see 2.1 just there to 1.9 with the multiplier. So for every bale JZD does, it is added on with the multiplier.
And you can tell how good these stackers are, right? Look at Hyper how he does it. Yes, he dropped a bale every now and then, but it's just beautiful what he does. And this game, it's a 40-point game right now, so...
It is. Like, yeah, I mean, they're very, very close.
Time, dude. There are only 30 seconds left. You need to get these bales over. You need to get the points.
This just shows as well how good the teams are. Like, one of the teams has the bale push, the bale press, right? So they get three bales at once. So they have three bales at once, and the other team only has one. But the scores are so close. Right,
yeah,
so
advanced JCD right now, unless Blackjack comes with a lot of bales, but I don't see that happening.
The Baler Streak, that's what I was looking for. Yeah, one team has the Baler Streak. So, it's pretty good. Anyway, with 5 seconds, it's coming pretty fast. There
1-0 JCD, but it is not over. We have seen how good Krone is, so they will put up a fight.
Yeah, big congrats to JCD. Baler Streak, they had a Baler Streak, right? So they managed to, it seems like they managed to be there, but both teams scored very close, so
big congrats. 31 bales, so it's only the multiplayer basically deciding, and of course there's one or two bales that go into the lower barn gate for Krona, but it was 31 bales to 31 bales. So
yeah, so it just shows really, if you have the bale streak, it doesn't necessarily mean you can't win or you can't lose, right? It means anything's possible still, right? It's everything's still random. Anyway, what's next? I guess the teams will be going against each other again. It is the best of three, everyone. Exactly. So we will be seeing Krone and JZD going against each other again. If JDZ wins this next round, then they've won and they're in the qualifiers, right?
Exactly. And then Krone would have to go up against Horsch.
Yes.
If Krone wins that one, we go to game three and see what's happening.
Yep.
And the JZD fans are in the chat. And this is not us. Again, Lars and Joe. Oh, no, that's me. I'm Lars. He's Joe. The two guys sitting there, it's Randy and Stefan, as you can see. The German commentators, our colleagues over at Giant Software DE, commenting for our German crowd. And we are sitting at home, nice. And
the English crashes are not on the screen, everyone. These are the German guys. You can see them just chatting there. Me and VF was talking last night. We was like, we wonder what they're talking about. Some people are pretty good at reading words from people's mouths and miming the words. We could maybe learn that as a skill.
I think Humor right now is talking about how... I have no idea.
We don't know. They're most likely talking about how the last game went on. And both teams really good, right? We just saw them... I mean, like we were saying, two very good teams, those two there. So,
or maybe they're talking about that left guy, Randy, because it's his birthday today. Congratulations, Randy.
Yeah, happy
on
birthday.
On his birthday, instead of sitting at home having cake, he came over to the Erlangen office to cast the Farming Simulator League, which is awesome.
And usually when we start to see all the six players in the bottom right, that is, we usually have about a minute left. So you can see we haven't got all the six players right now. We have one more to join.
Yeah. And then, as you said, from there...
It's about a minute.
Now it's about a minute.
Yes. So we'll be starting in about a minute's time when we see all the six players there in the bottom right. I'm looking forward to this next round. If JZD wins this next round, they are through. And they've essentially got into next month, right?
Mind-blowing as an American to see two people in the same room without masks. Well, I can tell you that. In Germany, we have a lot of security things as well. These two guys can sit right next to each other. They can't get any closer than they are right now. They are just not allowed to. And of course, as soon as they leave that spot, as soon as they get up, they're going to wear masks. It's just on screen that they don't have to.
Yeah, I mean, every country has different types of, you know, rules, right, for it. So, yeah.
Yeah. And we do have a lot of rules in Germany, but that's why we are in a very good position. So we can have these casters sitting there. But on the other hand, Joe and me, we can't be there. So
yeah, we're like, it's not that everything is easy over here. I don't know how many miles we are. What are we, like 1,000, 2,000 miles away? 3,000 miles? Yeah. I don't know. We're a long way.
And there we go. Game 2. Krone versus JZD. Krone needs to win that one. Otherwise, JZD won this group. And yes, if Krone wins that one, we're going to go to game 3, which would be awesome. I want to see these teams play against each other.
Yeah, I would like to see. I would like to see Krone win. That'd be quite a cool thing to see for this next game. And then we'll go over into game 3. But JZD, they're definitely going to try to win this next one. And then they are in. So they have got a lot of pressure in this next round.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. And if they do, then they go up against John Deere, which would be an absolute massive game in the quarterfinals.
Yeah, John Deere.
I totally want to see that.
John Deere second in the circuit points. So they're just in the Trailborg. Very, very good team. So if JDZ goes against them, they've definitely got something to go for.
Yeah.
Anyway, we're picking the vehicles right now. You can see all those vehicles just there have been banned. We're not missing a vehicle this time. No,
Krone obviously decided that they don't want to have the big tractors on the field anymore, so they banned the Deutz and the Fendt. Both of them have been in the last game.
Yeah,
so
changing the tactics.
Switch of tactics.
Yeah.
Change of tactics, of course.
And they picked the Vulture, going for some front loaders just here.
Yeah, the Vulture has been with Krone in the last match, so everything is just mixed up. The New Holland going to Krone, okay.
Yeah, it seems like they're changing the tactics of this round. It's absolutely quite nice to see. In last week, we saw Class, and they never even changed anything last week. And me and VF was like, oh, you know, they didn't change even a single thing. They just kept going and thinking they're going to get through and they're going to win. They didn't manage to do it, and that's why they lost.
Yeah,
so
it's just, if you know that your tactic doesn't work against an opponent, do something about it.
Yeah, you need to be adaptable, right? Yeah, you need to be adaptable.
And they just did. They have narrow tires now, which changes the way they're going to drive with the Horsch. So, and I think it's a good pickup because, you know, JZD is going for the grain boost. They do it all the time. So you really want to be sure to match this, and having narrow tires will help. They really, really need to get at least the ideal on the side of Krone, and they really, really need to get two bail presses to change things up. But against JZD, you really want the ideal, maybe the John Deere, to make sure that you can match what they do with harvesting, because these guys are good at harvesting.
Yeah, and you can see as well, the power play is exactly the same as last round. It seems like they're definitely focused on getting the tractors and everything going much faster.
I wonder for Krone if they want to pick these power plays or if they're just forced to pick them because they know JZD is doing it. And
maybe.
Again,
yeah,
they need to be fast, you know?
That could be true.
You can't pick something and be slower than these guys.
Yeah, the team,
if you are slower, you're screwed.
Yeah, I just want to say as well, the teams, it seems like some teams, they always hit the barrier. They try and position themselves to come out of the barrier on time as soon as it breaks. But sometimes they crash into it, and you saw just then on your screen, two of them just crashed into it. So, yes, not great. Anyway, and that does obviously slow time down as well. It does slow things down. Getting to these vehicles just there.
JZD might just be... Yeah, JZD got three harvesters. This is a nightmare for Krone.
Oh, no.
Krone has only the John Deere.
Oh.
This can't happen. But they do have three bailers, though.
Yeah,
do they have the fourth
one? Oh, we also have a bailer streak as well. This is what I was saying. This is what happened last week as well. We had a harvest streak, and we also had a bailer streak last week. And you know, we're having it again this week just here. It is actually better, though, to have
the
harvest streak.
And that's it. That's the fourth bailer. That means
it's a rush. We've had a rush.
Krone reacting. That
oh, my days.
Was beautiful.
Oh, wow. Big congrats there, everyone. We did not expect that.
Not what I expected. So for everyone who's super confused what happened now, here is what happened. It is called the rush. So what happens here is there are four bale presses and four harvesters on these pots, right? Everything can pick only once. Krone picked all four bale presses. That means that JZD isn't able to press a bale. And if you are not able to press a bale because you don't have a bale press,
you can't do the
game anymore.
Yeah, so then there's a rush.
So the game ends, and it's called a rush. So Krone, realizing that they have no chance to get four harvesters, just picked all the bale presses. And, well, that means that it's an automatic win.
Yeah,
we don't score points.
Yeah, we don't usually see rushes too often. We didn't see any last week. But yeah, we've had a rush this week. So yeah, big congrats to Krone. Now it's 1-1. So there will be another match, everyone. So don't worry, there is another match coming up. And so now, essentially, whoever wins this next match is through. And they're going to win. So
Tiny complaint from my side. When I said I want to see three matches, I want to see three matches played out.
I didn't
mean a rush. Thank you, Krone. But it's awesome for them. It was very well done.
It is
when
a key thing.
They can't win it anymore with Harvesters. They just picked the Baylors. Very well done.
It is a key thing in the game, and it is possible to do. It doesn't happen too often. I think it was changed in the early days to make it a little bit difficult. Yeah. But if you manage to do it, then yeah, it's a great advantage. So yeah. What's cool as well is we also had a Harvest streak and a Baylor streak, and then we had a Rosh. It all happened at the same time. It's pretty awesome.
You need to check out what the opposing team is doing, right? If you see they're going for all the Baylors, you need to pick up one. And usually they do. You don't see rushes happening pretty much anytime anymore. We have seen them in World Championships twice. Trelleborg, obviously the masters of rushes, they won tournaments with that tactic. Did it once, and now Krone did it. And I know it seems to be a very, very boring or very low tactic. But if you think about it, reacting to what the opposing team is doing by grabbing everything before they can, it's actually quite impressive. It's just, of course, we could run this game for 15 minutes, but what's the point if you know that JCD will stick at 0 points? As soon as Krone delivers one bail, the game is over. They can go all go and have a pizza.
I mean, the thing is, there's so many different vehicles to pick as well when they're going down off the podium when they're first starting. There's so many to pick, and you go in to get all the vehicles just there to get the rush before the other team. It is really, really impressive. So, and it's not easy. It's not an easy thing to do.
It was quite rare. It was. You know, if you don't have two harvesters after the beginning, then you are quite screwed, because having just one harvester will put you at a disadvantage, especially against JCD, because these guys are always going for grain boost. So only having one harvester basically makes you lose the game instantly. And then just turning around, reacting, and going, hey, we can have all bay presses. Anyway,
we're back again. You can see, I wonder if we'll see a rush this time. I don't think we will. Hopefully we don't. I do want to see this game play out. And like I say, it does happen rarely, so I think we'll see these two teams playing this time. Anyway, so again, we're back again. It was just a few minutes ago. We're back again. We're banning the vehicles. You can see Blackjack just there. What's he going to ban? Here we go.
I'm quite sure they do the same thing. The fence will most likely follow.
Yeah, I think they're going to do exactly the same.
Exactly. Yeah. They will pretty much do the same thing in case JCD is trying to get three harvesters again. They're going to rush them again or try to rush them again. I don't think it works twice, though. JCD knows this now. They've seen it now. They know what Krone is up to. But I'm quite sure Krone will at least make sure that in case they are in the same position, they can do the same thing.
Yeah, I just want to say as well, JCD, they are definitely under pressure this time. I mean, there was under pressure in the last round, but this time they really are, because, you know, this time, I mean, if John Deere wins, they're through into the qualifiers. If JCD wins, they're through as well, right? Whoever loses, they're into the losers round, the elimination match. So, yeah, it's definitely, these two teams definitely under pressure in this next round.
John Deere being Krone in this case.
Yeah.
You said John Deere. No, it's Krone.
Oh, I said John Deere. It's Krone. The green.
The green one is Krone. But whoever wins this match will face John Deere.
Yes.
That's for sure. Whoever wins this very match that's coming up right now will face John Deere on September 19th.
Yeah, the green baseball bats, caps that they have, they're definitely making me think the John Deere.
Yeah.
Anyway, they're picking all the same vehicles, you see. Pretty much all the same just there that they had in the last round.
For Krone, no need to change anything. They just won by rush, so they go for the same thing. For JCD, they are confident in, you know, I mean, they messed up. It's if you get rushed, it's not the other team destroying you. It's no one of your guys getting a single Baylor.
Yeah.
So they know they messed up a bit. So
it's quite hard to do that, actually. I mean, there's quite a few Baylors down there to get. They're going straight to them. The other team just managed to get them. I don't know. Yeah.
I think one of the problems here is you know exactly what Krone is going for. They go for the Krone press first. They will then go for the Fend, then for the Kuhn. And if you know that, if you are not sure you can make it, just don't go for the Krone at the same time. Just grab one of the others. You know, worst comes to worst, grab the New Holland, because that's the one Krone will go for last, usually.
Going back over, they hit the barrier again. That is like 3 seconds. Oh, no, he's flipped.
Is super bad for Blackjack. Oh, very, very bad start. However, if they manage to get the ideal and the case, then there is no harm in it. It's fine then. They got them both. Good for Krone. All good.
So, yeah, see, you see JCD, they've got into the New Holland Combine. They've also got the Fent Tractor. This just here is JCD. They've got the faster. They've got the Fent Bale just here, which obviously produces the bales
pretty
fast.
And they do exactly what I said. They just leave the Krone open and go like, okay, we're not going for the Krone press because they know exactly what's going to happen.
Harvest
However,
streak.
Oh, I wow. wonder... Krone's yeah, got I was about streak. to say, I think Crowley got three harvesters. They did. Putting JCP really, really on the back foot.
Yeah, so this is what I was going to talk about in the previous round before we actually had the rush. If you get the harvest streak, you are at a massive advantage because a harvester, it obviously gets the grain to be able to increase the multiplier, and it also puts down lots and lots of straw rows so you can make, you know, lots and lots of bales, right? So if you can get the harvest streak, which Crone has, you're at a huge advantage right now. So
especially against JCD, because again, JCD loves to go for grain boost, but they can't now. They have to go for bale boost, because if they go for grain boost, they are basically saying, hey, Krona, hey, win the game. Here, take it. So you have to get the bale boost and make sure that you get as many bales as possible. And for Krona, everything is set up. I mean, this team, they are strong and they are showing it now. They are really showing it now. So
yeah, they're a very, very, very powerful team. So currently, this is the, like we were saying earlier on, this is the preparation stage. This is when all the teams are just baling. Sometimes we'll see, most times we'll see them take the first bale to score double points. And they open up the Augur Trailer just there. You can see the New Holland just there on Team JCD. They've opened up the Augur Trailer so they can get that later on. And each team as well, they harvest differently. So some teams might do it the same. Some teams might do it differently. Some teams might go through the middle of the field. Some teams might start at the other end of the field. But usually they all try and head over through the Augur Trailer first with at least one combine.
That's the one thing you always want to do is make sure the horse is free, because you need to open it and you need to put it out. So whatever you do, you have one combine at least driving through the middle and opening that one up.
And here we go. Here is a look at the first bale being taken to the barn.
They most likely JCD will push it in the lower
maybe,
gate. Yeah, they usually do that. It's JCD usually does that, but they are not going for first bale right now.
Yeah, maybe he's going to just hook up to it and put it on the conveyor.
I don't think they will.
Or maybe not. Maybe he'll just leave it there. Interesting. Okay. Well, there we go. That's his decision.
Well, again, if you are JCD right now, you need to make sure that you get as many points as possible out of the bales.
Yeah.
Right? Because you don't have the grain. You'd only have one harvester. So yeah, I think what they plan to do is they plan to get the bale boost and then get that bale in for 60 points, because that would be 30 times two for first bale.
I think they might actually be putting it on right now.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they are. Interesting. Okay. So there we go. So, popping it on. So this is going to score 40 points because the very first bale of the match, everyone, the very, very first bale between both teams, that scores double points. So this bale just here is going to be 40. And in the future, every bale in there will be 20 unless the multiplier goes up.
There we go. 40-0. Advantage JZD. But again, this is just a preparation phase. It's not a big advantage. And we'll see what Krona is doing. Do you know, have you seen what the other press... Do they have two presses? Like, they do have the New Holland, and we can see it here. But another one?
I think I might have saw the Dudge, yeah.
So, I've seen the Fendt with JCD. That means that they would have the Krona as well. If that's the case, then there's huge advantage for Krona.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, they've got a massive advantage. I think whatever the case they have... But now they've got this harvest streak, this is just definitely going to benefit them so much, because they can obviously get the grain and obviously get lots and lots of straw rows as well for the baler. And it just gives them so much of an advantage. But JZD, they obviously now, instead of going for the grain, they obviously need to go for the bales.
Yeah, and they don't care about bridges. We've seen that before.
They just drive straight over. They just don't stop. They just carry on going straight over. It's pretty awesome to see. Obviously, adds a bit of hype into the game.
Absolutely does. Yeah, and Krona, I mean, they have no reason to hurry right now. Two harvesters on the field, something that JCD is not even able to do. Making sure they get a lot of grain. I'm quite sure they will, as soon as minute 8 hits, they will try to get the grain boost. If they do, it's pretty much game over. If bale boost is happening, there is a high chance that JCD is coming back. If grain boost is happening, I don't know how they would do it.
I don't know, yeah. If grain boost gets picked, then JCD, it'd be really cool if they did manage to do it with all these disadvantages in their not in their favor. But if they, you know, I guess it'd be hard.
I like how in the chat someone is going, oh, this could be sponsored by big companies, tractor producers. You know why the team is called Team Krona? Yeah. Because it is the team of the tractor and truck producer Krona.
Yeah, a lot of these teams,
the team John Deere and Klaas and Trelleborg, Porsche, Amazona, so many more. So many more. Komatsu Forest is there having a team. And I can promise you something. Next season, there will be teams we haven't seen this season. Because a couple more sponsors are getting ready for next season.
Yeah, this is going to be awesome, everyone. Like, each season, it's going to get better and better and better, FSL. And this is the first season where we actually have this new layout as well, with these two things. Exactly. In the previous season, it wasn't as this advanced. It was still pretty good, but it was just more just Bale focused. This game, just it. I mean, this whole new round, it's just all different now. There's many, many different types of things that the teams have to do. So it's much more advanced.
The league is evolving, right?
Yeah,
in season
definitely.
One, it was a Bale stacking competition, more or less. Season two, now we have this, the game you can see here now. And I can promise you, season three, we're going to see a step forward as well. Because we are constantly working on the game, of course, making it better. So while we probably likely stick to the Bales, of course, this is the core of the game. There will be changes. So season three will be more interesting.
Yeah.
Or different.
Anyway, we are 30 seconds out from the drone drop. Drone drops take place between the 6 to 8 minute mark for anybody new in the chat. And you can see just here, we have the combine unloading into the Ogre trailer. Everything's got a little bit quiet. You can see it seems like they're just picking the bales up.
Yeah.
The combine's right in the field though. They're still going. I think the ideal is, it looks like the ideal is absolutely jam-packed full. Here it is.
It absolutely is. Yeah. And again, Krona this time, they really want the grain boost. Turns out they have the Kuhn press as well. So Kuhn and New Holland for them. Press advantage for JZD, if you want to say so, because the Fend is the fastest and the Krona has three bales to pick. So they do have good bale presses. However, that is their only harvester, the New Holland. So we will see that one out on the field for probably the entire game now.
Yes. All right, so we're coming up to the 7 minute mark now as well. Any minute now, the drone drop is going to take place. We'll keep a lookout for it. Oh, you can see, there is the drone right now. The drone is in the field. It's going to drop. And like we were saying earlier on, JZD, they need to get the bail points. All right. They need to get the bail points. If they don't get it, they are.
And they know it.
They've kind of lost, really. But
you can see it here. He's right under the drone. Not too close, because if this thing drops the wrong one on your head, you pick it up by accident. So you have to stay close to it, but you can't just be under it. Otherwise, you might just, you know, doom your team. But he's ready.
He
knows what he needs.
Yeah, he's going back and forth, right?
Frisky Frog and everyone else, if you want to know how to do this, and by the way, hello Mr. CDP, nice to see you out there.
Mr. CDP, hello.
If you want to play this for and join the league, fsl.giants-software.com, just sign up there and you can sign up for the tournaments next season. Of course, you can't join this season because World Championship is an invitational. We invite the 16 teams, so you can't join anymore, but next season is absolutely possible.
Yeah, I just want to say to everyone in the chat, if you guys are enjoying the stream, don't forget to share the stream as well over on social media. Get the word out. This is, you guys are enjoying it. I'm sure many other people will enjoy it as well. So, yeah, don't forget to share the stream. All right. So, has the drone drop taken place? I don't think it has. Like 20 seconds
out. That is just bad for JCD because Melly is waiting for that drop to happen for like 1.5 minutes
now.
Big
stop.
And Melly has to go all the way around.
Green.
And then Krona was like, yeah, let's take the grain boost. Bye, guys.
Okay, so this is not good for JZD right now.
This is disastrous. Melly spent an entire 2 minutes waiting for that drop just to not get it in the end.
This is terrible. So, like we say, everyone, because Krone has the harvest streak, okay, JZD needs to get this bale boost to be able to, because they just don't have enough bales. They just cannot produce enough bales. So they need to get this bale points, and they haven't got it.
No.
So, the chances are...
You can see 32,000 liters. Krona is like, let's put that nail in the coffin. Let's finish this now.
Yeah, let's just absolutely nuke them. Yeah, you can see just there. This is JZD. They are stacking their bales. They need to get these bales on now, but they just don't have enough. They just don't have enough bales compared to Krona.
They need to get as many bales up there as fast as possible, because right now they do have a multiplier of 2.0.
Yeah,
but
if they can get them on now.
As soon as Krona starts delivering,
they
will never recover from it.
So this is essentially like... this is essentially the end of the match. I'm not going to say it is. Anything could happen in 5 minutes. Yeah. Things can change. But like this is not good for JZD right now.
No, look at this. It's 19,000 compared to the 32,000 that Krona had. This is just what happens now. This multiplayer will never in this game go back into JZD's favor.
Yeah, this is bad.
And Krona's just waiting it out. They have enough. They're just waiting it out. And as soon as JZD starts unloading, they just keep the multiplier up.
Yeah,
it is very, very strong position.
You can see Krone as well. They're not even putting the bales on right now. They're at 30, like 30 points, and JZD, they're 180. It seems like they're just waiting.
All the time now.
Yeah, they know that they have got a massive, massive chance to win this today.
2.8 to 1.2.
Yeah, the Crashing as well. That's not good for JZD.
This is a nightmare. You only get 12 points.
Just look
now
at this, everyone.
Look at this.
Oh my God.
All the points coming in now.
Oh, wow. Cronin's
like, that was what we are waiting for. Take
a mother
this
load of bales.
Oh boy.
This is like a mother load of bales just going on. That is like the perfect shot. Oh, wow. Yeah, just you watch the scores for Cronin, everyone. Just watch this go up in the top left. Watch this go up. It's going to go up absolutely crazy in the next 3 minutes. 4 minutes. Yeah. It's going to go so high. JZD, I mean, they are at a huge disadvantage right now.
Yeah, if you think about it, if JZD gets two bales in, that's 24 points, right? For Krone, one bale is 28. So you need three bales. As if you are JZD, you need three bales to more or less match the points Krone is doing with one bale. And look at how many bales they have.
I'm just laughing at how many bales they have. And the thing is, every one bale they have, every bale that goes in, look at the multiplier as well. The multiplier is just going to be, just watch this go up, everyone. This is just going to be absolutely unbelievable.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Krone is just showing why they used to be one of the most dominating teams in the league. As we said, during the last two or three tournaments, they didn't anymore, but they are back now. And
Someone's saying, why is the blue's conveyor so slow? Because the multiplier, you can see the multiplier underneath the timer just there, the blue multiplier, that is up really high. That means for every per bale, it's times 2.8. However, it obviously slows their conveyor belt down as well and makes other teams' conveyor belt much faster. So for you wondering that, that's how it works.
You have to find the balance, basically. So you can tell, you can see it on the left side of that multiplier. It's 20% conveyor belt speed for Krone right now and 180% speed for JZD. So JZD is scoring very fast, but only a few points, so there's no point.
I think JZD might just give up.
How do you change the multiplier? By delivering a grain to the silo. So the multiplier is always 4.0, and it works like a scale. It starts with 2.0, and then if you deliver grain, the scale tips into your direction, goes up to 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, and so on, and goes down for the opposing team. And if they deliver grain, the scale tips in the other direction, getting your multiplier up, and you know. So that's how it works. Krone delivered way more grain, but they had three harvesters, so it was easy for them. 2.8 is the multiplier, and yeah, they are just destroying JZD right now. This is brutal.
Yeah, somebody says in chat, could we see 900 in the score? Have we seen that before, 900? I think we might have.
I think Class is the only team that ever hits that high.
Yeah, that is pretty high.
Yeah, it's very hard to see 900 without the bale boost, because even with 28 points per bale, it's, you know, you need the bale boost to score
you need
400, 500 during that boost window to hit 900. So this could be an 800 round, but 900 with a grain boost, I don't see that coming.
Yeah, I mean, if you could get like a harvest streak and a bale streak, I mean, you're set if you can do that. It helps you so much.
Absolutely.
Anyway, we're at 1 minute 15 pretty much now, and you can see, look at these scores. 700 nearly, 673 for Krone, and 348 to JZD. I mean, you're just completely obliterating them. This will be a high
800 round, but no 900. I don't think.
They can't turn this around now, JZD, I don't think.
No. If you score 800 points against JZD, that has to be scary for John Deere. Because if Krone wins that one, and I'm telling you now, they will, that's the matchup. It's Krone versus John Deere in the quarterfinals. And John Deere, being a very, very good team, they are struggling against JZD. They have struggled against JZD a lot. JZD is so strong. And then they get put into place by Krone so hard.
Yeah, this is like, means that they
if
must
you are
worry.
John Deere, you're like, oh God, I don't want to do this.
Yeah,
but then
definitely.
Again, if you are Krone, you are also going, oh, I don't want to play John Deere. And that's why the quarterfinals will be hype.
Yeah, it just shows how good these teams are. I mean, Krone, they are third for a reason, right? They are in the circuit points, they're third for a reason. It's because they're such a good team. And you can see from this just here, like, just look how many points they have. So there we go, 700 and what are we at? 733? Looks like it's 733. So big congratulations.
I thought they were going to make 800, but they didn't. Slowed down in the end.
Big congratulations to Krone. That is awesome.
GG. You are the winner of Group C. You will face John Deere.
Just look at the points difference. That was absolutely unbelievable. The score just there. That just shows what a harvest streak can do. If you can get the harvest streak and you can get the grain boost as well, like, you're set. You can win. That is big stuff.
That was just very well played by Krone, outplaying JZD basically on their turf, going with the grain boost and showing them that Krone is a force to reckon with. That means, as I said, Krone John Deere first quarter final is set.
Yeah,
the second quarter final. Oh, yeah. Sorry.
I was going to say as well, next up, we have the teams going against each other again from earlier on, the opening match. We have JZD versus Horsch again next.
Exactly.
Right. So
Horsch
this
needs
is
to find a way now.
Yeah, this is the thing about... This is the cool thing about these group stages. The teams can actually compete again if they lose. And because JZD has lost this winner's match and Horsch lost the opening match, they're competing again. So, yeah.
Exactly. This is so... It's way easier if I see you and know when you are talking.
I know, it's hard, isn't it? Right?
Sorry if we sound very weird sometimes. that's just me basically screwing that up. What I wanted to say is, whoever wins that next match, JCD versus Horsch, will be in the quarterfinals against the Burning Gamers by Stark. So that's the match they are fighting for right now, for the quarterfinals.
Yeah. I'm ready to play now. Put me in the game now. I came here to prove it. I'm ready to do it. I can't be afraid now. Put me on the stage now. I'm ready to rage now. I feel like an animal stuck in a cage and I'm ready to break out. So what are you afraid of? Those feelings are made of. Get in the game, your moment of fame. Show them what you made of. It's time that we stand up. It's time that we man up. For anyone asking who is the best, we putting our hands up. My time, my time. None of you people can tell me to stop. This time, like the last time, you better get ready to race to the top. I'm ready to do this, show you what the truth is. I step on the field, it's time to get real. I'm feeling so ruthless. My time, my time. None of you people can tell me to stop. Lower the lights down. Hand over my crown. Hand over my heart. I do this for my town. I do this for my crowd. So turn me up real loud. My time, my time. None of you people can tell me to stop.
I'm running out of time, every day goes by so fast. And every moment counts, baby, I don't wanna miss a thing. We can sleep under the stars, we can sleep under the stars. Or hang out in hotel bars, driving somewhere in your car. We can sleep under the stars, we can sleep under the stars. Under the stars.
Okay, everyone, welcome back to Farming Simulator League. Next up, we have got the opening match from earlier on, but it's the elimination match next. This is going to be JZD versus Horsch. So those two are going to be going against each other next. Horsch lost earlier on against JZD, and JZD won. So there's a potential possibility that JZD are going to win this next one. What do you think, Lars?
Yeah, I think they will, unless Horsch comes up with something here.
Yes.
Horsch tried two different tactics against JCD. Both didn't work. So if everything goes like it did in the first game, that should be easy for JCD. However, you never know what Horsch comes up with. So
yeah.
I hope it will be an interesting losers finals. Maybe three games. I would love to see three games. Please, Horsch.
We want to see three.
give us three games. It would
because Amazon, they obviously had some bad internet connections earlier. The timing of today, like, it's not going to be as long today, so we really want to see another three matches next. That'll be that'll be awesome to see.
Exactly. We are basically losing out on two full matches, right?
Yeah.
Amazon didn't happen, and Amazon and Horsch didn't happen either, because Amazon could make it, so they would lose both. And we see here.
Yeah, these are some replays. Look, Blackjack attempted to get the fent, and it just couldn't get it in time.
That was the first match,
and then
though.
And then the bale as well went flying just there from Mr. Massels. He just crashed into it, and it went flying.
Yeah. And
I think there was another problem just there. What happened just there? Oh, yes, they crashed into each other. Kind of rushing.
Yeah, they played that first game very, very weird.
Yeah, they did pretty bad. Yeah.
But then they had two awesome games, and everything was fine.
Yes, somebody says in chat, can the commentators explain the picking and banning phase? Yes, we'll talk about that in a few minutes once we get over to it. Definitely.
Yeah, we can totally do that.
Absolutely. You can see the bale just there. The bale was just rolling on top of the hood just there of the tractor. That was pretty cool. Oh, wow. Yeah, that was a cool... That was some pretty cool rounds. Yeah, I mean, obviously we had a rush as well. That was awesome to see. Very rare. Rushes don't usually happen that often. So it was, big pro to them for getting the rush. And we also had, I think, in the time when we had the rush, we also had a Baylor streak and also a Harvest streak as well at the same time.
Yeah, everything was going on in that game. The shortest game of the match. Wasn't the shortest. They at least played. Amazon still has the shortest game with 0 seconds. By the way, that's not us.
Yes, this is the German casters, everybody. I'm in the UK, the English caster, and Lars, he's in Germany as well. He's obviously speaking English right now, and he's at the FAMSIM offices. There you go. That was the rush.
I try my best to speak English. Sometimes, maybe it's because of the heat. Sometimes my brain just melts, and you know, I lose my English. But then I have you to correct me and make the best out of my brother.
Yeah, I think you're pretty good.
Sometimes I really feel like I'm losing the words. And I lived in England and UK, in UK and Ireland for a combined 9 years. So I think my English should be fine, but
right.
I don't know. Oh, that was the tech just coming.
Okay.
Tech
so
is
10 seconds.
Telling us that we have more replays coming in. Nice.
Yeah, looking forward to that. Yeah, replays are really cool because you get to see what happened in the previous rounds, right?
Yeah. I think this is probably the guy just jumping again. JCD, as I said, they don't care about bridges. They just jump.
Yeah, they don't care. They just go straight over them. I think they must practice off screen at being able to go over the bridges, you know, even when they're shut like this.
This is so sad. He was on the wrong side, you know? He could have picked that one, but he didn't want because that was the grain boost. So he was just waiting for this drone to drop, and then he was on the wrong side of the drone.
And you can see, this is what happened. And then, yeah, that was the point in the game when they lost, really, to be honest. Because, obviously, the harvest streak was taking place. They needed to get the grain, and that was really the moment when they lost. When they got the bale, they didn't pick the bale drop, but they picked the grain.
Yeah.
Anyway, that was. I mean, you saw just then as well with all the bales going on. Krohn absolutely obliterated them with all those bales going onto the conveyor at one time. Absolutely crazy. I mean, so many bales going on. They was just ready to completely obliterate the other team when that grain boost was picked from the drone drop.
Yeah. So here I have an interesting, tricky question for you, Joe.
Okay.
With so Krohn won that one, and they are now in a bracket with John Deere, which is, just judging by circuit points, the second best team in the league, and they are in the same bracket with Trelleborg, which is just by circuit points the best team in the league. So JZD by losing made it into the bracket without these two powerhouses. They are now in a bracket with, if they win that one against Horsch, they are in a bracket with the Burning Gamers and Grimme. So here's my question. Burning Gamers beat John Deere, and Grimme obviously beat everyone in Group 1, so they are above Trelleborg right now. Would you rather be in the bracket with the two teams that are the best on paper but lost in the World Championship, like Krohn, or would you rather be in the bracket with the two teams that are technically on paper worse, but but you know, have won? So what bracket would you prefer, while we talk about it, because the server will restart, so we have another minute or something?
That's actually a really, really good question. I guess I don't know, that's actually such a good question, because I mean, they've won overall, you know, with the circuit points and things, those teams, but they haven't, I don't know. I don't know. I guess sometimes they can win, sometimes they can't. And I have no idea.
Before the World Championship started, if I would tell you, look, you have choice. You can go into the bracket with John Deere and Trelleborg.
Yeah.
Or you can go into the bracket with Grimme and the Burning Gamers. Which one would you pick? And you would most likely, oh, wait, I'm completely wrong, by the way. Because John Deere finished second, John Deere and Trelleborg are not in the same bracket.
Exactly.
They are in a bracket. John Deere's in a bracket with Grimme.
Yeah, like on paper, you know, they are the winners. But obviously, here in the FSL, in the ending just there, they haven't done as good. So, I would probably I'd probably still go with what's on paper, but there's still a chance to go wrong, right? So
I was completely wrong because I forgot that John Deere was second. So that means that you play John Deere and then you play against the winner of Grimmer versus whoever is second next week. So Trelleborg for Krone, Trelleborg can only be there for them in the finals. However, you have John Deere as a game. So for JCD, you will, or Horsch, whoever wins that match, you will face the Burning Gamers, but then there is Trelleborg next. So, September 19th can't fast enough.
Yeah, next month is going to be absolutely awesome because we're going to see the top teams. We're going to see Trelleborg, we're going to see John Deere, we're going to see Krone, possibly JCD. I don't know, I guess we'll see who wins. But it's just, they're all such good teams. And even though Trelleborg is at the top in circuit points and they've managed to get so many, the other teams are so good that there is a chance Trelleborg, we've always thought throughout the whole of FSL that Trelleborg could potentially win, be the winners. But there is a chance they might not. You know, the other teams are very, very good. And all it takes is a little bit of disruption to disrupt Trelleborg. And if you can disrupt them, if you can disrupt their game, you can win. So, next month is going to be awesome. You guys in the chat, you guys have to definitely tune in.
Yeah, and you should tune in next week because Group D is an absolute nightmare for every team. There's the Landeier in there, which they started as a wildcard team, but they were so good that they managed to get a sponsor after the first tournament. There's Lindner in there. They started weak, but they are super strong right now. There's WK, which is the sister team of JZD. They are fantastic. And there is Landwirtschaft 3.0, a team that has only played twice in the entire tournament, but finished second in the first one, and got dropped out because of an player injury, which sounds super weird for this game, but there was a player injury for Landwirtschaft 3.0. So
maybe he broke his finger with a keyboard or something.
he broke his leg, actually, way to the tournament. So.
Okay. Well, I guess that can happen. Somebody in chat was asking about the banning phase. Essentially, this is the phase where they pick what tractors they don't want to pick later on today. Each tractor, everyone, acts differently. Some tractors are faster, some tractors are more powerful, some tractors move, and they have some, I mean, like the JCB, for example, all the wheels can turn on that. It's really, really fast, the JCB, the yellow one that's been banned. Each tractor is different, right? Some, the stayer just there that's been banned, that has care wheels, so you can drive through the crops. And you can see right now, these are the vehicles that are being picked. And you can see we have a massive Fendt 1050 and also a Deutz. Two very, very powerful tractors. And
these are the fastest as well. Both of them are 63 kmh, the Fendt and the Deutz. Very powerful tractors. However, they don't have a front loader, so they can't pick up bales. Then, Horsch is going for super fast.
Yeah, I like setup. I'm really glad that they've gone for the telehandler. That's really nice to see. Because you get to see them putting all the bales really high on the conveyor belt. So I'm looking forward to seeing that. But yeah, for the person that was wondering, for the people that are wondering, each tractor acts differently. So it is important. They all know what these different types of vehicles do and how they're handled.
We can go over the six that we see here very quick. The telehandler, as you said, able to put the bales on the conveyor belt at a very, very high position. The Deutz, the big green and black one in the middle on the left side, is a big, fast tractor, 63 kmh. And the New Holland is one of the fastest tractors as well. So Horsch with a very fast setup.
Yeah,
and they're going chip tuning slide edge. They want to rush.
Yeah, and the New Holland they definitely are. And the New Holland as well, that is very good for connecting to the Krone baler. I mean, you can connect it, you can use the Krone baler even with that small New Holland. So it's very, very versatile. You can do quite a bit with it.
Yeah. On the other side, we have seen the Fendt, the big Fendt in the middle. That one, the Fendt 1050, very fast as well. Narrow tires or care wheels, I think. Whatever they are called. As you said, you don't get stopped. And Horsch is rushing down, but they are not rushing. They're just fast.
This is going to be a cool game to see because obviously JZD, they won. These two teams just here, for everyone, they competed against each other early on, right? So, and Horsch lost then. So Horsch could potentially lose on this round just here. JZD are a very, very, very good team.
And so, look at how fast Horsch is picking up the balers. If Marcel gets that one, that will be... they did. They have the Krone. They have the Fendt. The Kuhn is still open. So
yep, you can see the Kuhn just there.
JZD got the Kuhn, so it's not a rush.
Yeah, there's no rush. That's there's no Baylor streak so far.
But it's a very nice setup for Horsch. They have the case and the John Deere combines. They have the Krone and the Fendt press. So very good setup for Horsch. Very good setup as well for JZD, the ideal. being probably the most sought after harvester right now. Everyone wants that one. The New Holland there. So yeah, it's a very, very fair setup. And again, Porsche didn't play too bad against JCD. They just need to be faster. Maybe they are now.
Yeah, definitely. And you can see already they are starting to harvest the fields. They're starting to bale as well. And yeah, they're just opening these Ogre trailers up and getting the first bale ready to be taken to the barn to score double points. That's what they're going to be doing.
Yeah. And just about to pick a bad face, because we do have a little bit of time right now while the games, the teams are preparing everything.
Yep.
Similar to other games that have a pick and ban phase, every tractor is there just once, right? So if you ban something, both teams can't pick it. And if you pick something, the other team can't pick it either. I mean, I guess that was obvious, but I just wanted to mention it. Just
yeah. Oh, the Deutz has crashed. That's not good.
Yeah. That's when you take a fast tractor like that one.
Yeah, he's got a really fast tractor with really heavy bale on the back, so you've got to be super careful what you do with it. But it seems like he's going to be putting the first bale into the bottom drawer door, so that is 20 points. There we go. So Horsch has won the first bale just there. Big congrats.
And again, they went for super fast machines.
Oh, yeah.
But everything Horsch has, the telehandler is super fast.
Yeah, it seems like Horsch might want to try to beat JZD with speed.
Yeah, and they have to. Yeah. They were slower, but they were good, so now they have to be faster. That's how to win the game. And maybe you don't want to get the grain boost to JCD again, because JCD is so good when they have the grain boost. Maybe you want to go for the baler boost and then just use your telehandler to get as many bales as possible and get as many points as possible. That's how you throw off JCD. But
you you can see they're opening the Ogre Trail just now, and they've opened it up, and the combines, within the next couple of minutes or so, the combines will start to unload to get ready to take that to be unloaded. I can see Virtual Farm in the chat. VF, hello. Welcome to the stream.
Oh, this guy's taking a day off and then he's just watching it. Makes me do all the work. I can't believe it, VF. Shame on you, my friend.
I think he's just taking it off to watch. Oh, wow.
I see asking what's the difference with the two doors. So, the barn has two gates or two doors, the lower one and the upper one.
Yes.
A bale always is worth 10 points. That's just how it works. So if you put a bale into the lower door, because that is just a door, you get 10 points per bale. If you use the conveyor belt to get it into the higher, the upper door,
20 points.
That's exactly. That's 10 points times the multiplier you see on the top of your screen. It's 2.0 for both teams. So right now that would be 20 points. If you increase that multiplier, it would be 21, 22, and so on. While the lower door will always stay at 10.
Yeah, and like we say, to increase the multiplier, you obviously take the grain to the unload point, and you start unloading. But that usually doesn't start happening until we start seeing the drone drop, really, which will be happening between the 6 to 8 minute mark. So, awesome stuff. Anyway, you can see the team's preparing, getting all the bales. We don't have any baler streaks, and we don't have any harvest streaks on this round. It's just, Horsch has just got a lot of fast equipment. So that's, I guess that's the only advantage Horsch has right now.
And that's what they aim for. You can tell, because everything they picked is just fast.
I mean, they really need to win this. They do not want to. If they lose this, everyone. I mean, it is the best of three. But if they lose this against JZD, they're out. And it's the same for JZD. If JZD lose this against Horsch, they're out of FSR. Like, there's no coming back in this season. So this best of three just here is very, very important for these two teams. It's either means they're going to win. And get it through to next month, or it means they're going to fail and they're going to be out.
Yeah, it's the entire season on the line, basically. And in addition, because Horsch lost two games against JCD earlier today, they really need to lead 1-0. They need to put pressure on JCD, right? It's all about momentum. If you can turn it around now, and if you win that first game as Horsch, you are basically sending a message to JCD going, we are after you guys. We are here. If you lose that one again, it's JCD saying, yeah, it's so easy, guys. We beat you every time. So it's about sending a message, really.
Yeah, it is. It certainly is. You can see this ideal combine just here, this black ideal. This is the Fendt version. This has the most grain. This can actually hold the most grain. So if a team has this, they do have a pretty powerful combine. So, yeah.
Yeah, and it's also driving at 13 kmh without chip tuning, slide edge, everything. Just, you know, the raw harvester is 13 kmh. So it's quite fast and can store a lot of grain. So it's really, really good.
If a team can get that, definitely gives them an advantage. Someone says in the chat, do we know if any of these guys are farmers in real life?
Some of them are, yeah. They absolutely are. Deutz Freak, I think, is working for at least for one of the farming companies. Monty, and sorry for the horse team, he has a farm. I know that because I was there when he bought the tractor on Agritechnica last year. I don't know for the JCD guys, and I know for sure that Mr. Marcel is not. So at least two out of the five, out of the six.
Yeah, and we also have Amazon as well. They all work for Amazon.
Yeah, all of them are farmers.
Yes. So yeah, yeah, there is good. We are farmers. Yeah, someone in chat. Yeah, there is some farmers who are in the FSR. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, a lot of players actually are farmers. The Grimma team, they're all farmers. I don't know for every single team, but a lot of farmers in this league.
And you can see all the grain just there. Look at that, so much grain. That is what's gonna bring their multiplier up eventually in a few minutes time.
I want to see them farm in real life. Well, I can tell you they are not doing this in real life.
Yeah. Oh no, it's crashed. Oh no.
Again.
I just saw that.
It's gone
in the ditch as well. Oh, that bale is gone forever now.
Yeah.
There's no point going. There's no point. I mean, he does have a telehandler. He could potentially try and get it out.
Yeah.
But I don't think, I don't know. I think he might load it.
Oh, very early drone drop. It's there. And it is. Oh, JCD picked up the bale boost.
Bale boost.
Interesting.
Oh, look at that bale. It's just in the water. That thing is now going to rot. And, well, it would in real life anyway, but it's just going to sit there. Yeah, it's just sat there now, all upset.
It's 30 points, you can tell if you look at the top of the screen. The multiplier is up to 3.0 now. Whatever you do, it sticks to 3.0 for the next 1 minute and 55 seconds. You can see that on the minimap. That is
the bales.
We haven't seen it today. So
yeah, and the bales are now going to start being loaded up. This is the moment. I mean, as we've got the bale boost, the bales are now going to start loading up. All the time now, we're going to see loads from Horsch, loads from JZD. And we're also going to start seeing the two auger trailers being taken to the unload point to raise the multiplier. So any moment now, I'm sure we'll see that.
Do that once the power-up is over, because there's no point in doing it now.
Oh, no. Like I was saying earlier on with the telehandler, the cool thing about this, you can see, they can actually put the bales pretty high on the conveyor belt. If your conveyor belt is really slow because of the multiplier and you have a telehandler, you can actually put your bales really high, and you don't have to wait as long for those bales to get in. So it is a good advantage.
Yeah, that's when it shines. That's why you want to have it if you go for a lot of grain, because then even if your belt is at like 20%, you just put the bales on the very top of the belt, and you don't care about the 20%. That's when it's at its strongest, basically.
Yeah.
Right now, because we have the bale boost instead of the grain boost, it's not showing the full potential, but that might happen later in the game. 6 minutes left.
I'm sure we'll see.
It's a 10-point game right now.
Yeah, and we have 20 seconds left of the bale boost as well. So I'm sure we'll start seeing the multiplier going up in around 10 seconds time now.
Technically, he could use it now. There are only like 8 seconds left. You really want to use the telehandler to get that bale in there, but I don't think he's doing it.
You can see on the map as well on the bottom left, both teams just there. They are both heading over to the unload point.
And it's over, 290 to 240. Well done.
There we go.
Horsch.
We're now
and
seeing.
Now they start unloading right away. Horsch was ready.
Yeah, this is when the big stuff's going to start taking place now, everyone. We're going to see all the points going up. They're pretty close currently, 290 to Horsch.
Well done.
The 240 to JZD. But we're going to start seeing this go up.
Horsch really, really learning from the first game. Everything they do is super fast now. Super fast bales, super fast unloading. It's way better timing than they had before. It's putting a lot of pressure on JCD.
Yeah, in the previous game, they did not do good. They were slow and they completely lost. But now, it seems like they're back.
Yeah, and all of a sudden, it seems that Horsch has a fighting chance here. And that's exactly what I was talking about when I said it's all about momentum, right?
Yeah.
Horsch putting pressure on JCD after they just lost against Krone might actually do something to the team mentally. I don't think it will, because JCD is such a strong-minded team. But it could. And JCD is getting that multiplier in their favor. This is nice for the guys in red.
Okay,
this
this is what JCD is good at. They are a very, very good team. And you can see it's now in their favor. And we do expect that JCD will probably win, because they're such a good team in terms of circuit points compared to Horsch. But we have seen before in previous games going against Trailborg. I think we saw in like group stage A. In that the opening match, Trailborg lost against someone there. So
against the team of Elite. If you want to talk about circuit points, Trailborg has 910 circuit points. They won 9 out of the 11 tournaments they ever played.
Finished
second once.
Yeah.
Team of Elite guys, They only had 30 points. They never won a tournament. They never made it to quarterfinals. However, they beat Trelleborg 2-0 and just got kicked them out of the winner bracket.
I know, and I think Team of Elite guys, I think they only recently just joined or something, right? They haven't even been here for the whole thing.
They only played two tournaments.
I know, it's crazy. Like they managed to beat the top team, the number one team, and they haven't even been here for that long. I mean, it just shows in the next season. Oh no, they've crashed.
Oh, this is terrible, guys.
What
is he trying? He's trying to get that one bail. Well, you know, at least he gets the bail back.
Okay, well, yeah, but he's now going to have to try and get out of there in time.
Nicely done.
Yeah, I don't know. That's, maybe it would have been worth just leaving the bail, but maybe it means something, the bail. I guess we'll see.
Well, he does have the time, though, because both bail presses are there. So he does have the time to pick it up. I don't know if it's a good choice or not, but these guys are the professionals. I'm just the caster.
Yeah, they've taken the risk. Yeah, they've taken the risk. Yeah, you can see this bail must mean something to them. Yeah, straight back out as fast as he can.
And he can and I love that the chat is picking that up. He can totally Grimmer dive this way out, because that's Grimmer invented a way to just ignore the bridges. And that's why we call it the Grimmer dive. And the chat is picking it up. So that means we do have fans out there who are watching the whole thing. Nice to have you guys back. Hello.
Yes, welcome back. Grimmy dive, you can just... This is the thing, this is the cool thing about the bridges. You can just drive... If it starts going up when you're coming towards them, then you're not going to get over it, right? You're going to have to pick another one. But if it starts going up when you're this side of the barn, then you can just fly straight over it, and you should be perfectly fine if you get the timing right. So,
And if you don't have bales, you can totally ignore the bridges if you know how to. But with bales, you don't want to jump. If you do, you lose the bales. But if you're driving from the barn to the field without bales, you can do it. And look at this, a 3-point game right now.
Yeah, this is awesome. Like we're at 2 minutes and it's so close. But anything can happen. Like we've said before, 2 minutes, anything can happen in 2 minutes. 2 minutes is a lot of time for Farming Simulator League. Lots of different things can happen. But we're currently JZD 513. Look at that, 1 point.
And
that is crazy.
This is the difference in multiplayer. Yeah, it's 21 points per bale for JZD and only 19 for Horsch. So every bale they both deliver, it's 2 points more for JZD. So Horsch needs to deliver at least a bale more in total, in order to win this one.
In the pick and ban phase, I was saying that little new Holland just there can handle the chrome baler, and you can see just there, it is handling it. It can drive it. It can bale with it. It's such a small, nimble tractor. It really is, and it's got the power. It's definitely got the power.
It is the most picked tractor.
It's like a powerhouse.
Because it is that good.
Yeah.
Look at these bales. Oh no, they use both. Well done. It wasn't even close. Not even. Because if you get stuck there and the tractor in front of you is raising the bridge, you are stuck for like 30 seconds.
Yeah, those bales was like opened up in like a wing position just there, coming through that bridge. We've seen people crash before when the bales have been in that sort of position. So, yeah, I was kind of thinking he might hit the bridge, but he managed to get through. And we're currently 1 minute left.
How good these guys are.
Yeah, look at that. 1 minute left, everyone. And both Horsch are winning currently. 607 to 553 to JZD. Now, we thought JZD might win this. There's a chance that it could be Horsch, I think.
There is a high chance that Horsch is coming back here. All bridges are up, so you have to go all the way around Deutz Freak.
As I said,
this guy used to be... I think in the beginning of the league, we had a spotlight on Deutz Freak talking about how good as a stacker he is.
Yeah, he's great.
He fall out of grace when it comes to stacking because, as we said, his internet is now not good enough to practice anymore. But
yeah, he was good.
Do it, so.
He was good, but yeah, because of the internet.
20
anyway,
seconds.
What are we at now? This is like, okay, this isn't good. You can see Horsch just here. No, JZD just here. They have no bales. And
oh,
the humor
five
is only just bringing
5 points. It's a 5 point
this is
game.
Crazy.
Horsch is leading by 5 points. Will
they get
15,
the bales in?
5 seconds. Is there anything they can do? No!
No!
1-0
Horsch has won.
Nice!
Wow, that is
awesome. We have a game
now,
guys.
Big congrats, everyone. So that means there could potentially be another 2 matches next.
Wow. That's beautiful. That's what I was hoping for.
That is great. Big congrats to Horsch.
1-0 Horsch. And now JCD is back against the wall. If they lose another one, they are out of the tournament.
Yeah, that was... We was expecting JZD to win this because JZD is so good. But like I was saying, you can actually beat these big teams. You can beat these really good teams. It is possible. And just there from Horsch, you can see they managed to do it. So yeah, big congrats.
And as we said, Horsch used to be a very strong team.
They didn't
show up the last two tournaments. But we are hyping JZD. That's just because they had such an impressive run over the last 4 or 5 tournaments. And Horsch just didn't. And now Horsch is just back to doing what they can. They were super fast. I'm quite sure they will go for a super fast tactic again. And all of a sudden, they are putting a lot of pressure on JCB. And this is exactly what I wanted. Very beautiful. This audio is not lagging. These guys are the Germans. We are obviously not speaking German. That's because we are not on screen.
Yeah, we're the English casters. We are not on the screen. These are the German guys. Because of the current situation in the world and everything, we can't get over there to the offices right now. Over to the studio to do this on camera. So yeah, that is the reason, everyone. We're just talking over them right now. Exactly. Yeah, you can see people in the chat that are saying they didn't expect that. Yeah, we didn't expect that either, really. No. I mean, it is possible to beat these teams, but I mean, we didn't expect it, really. JCD, Horschel actually lost to JCD earlier on, right? Earlier on in the game, in the opening match. So yeah, we did not expect it. But you can see, we have another match coming up. If Horsch wins this next match, they are through and they have qualified.
But you
if
know
they
what?
Lose, then JZD wins.
Yeah, I love World Championships for exactly that. In Group 1, I did not expect Trelleborg to lose a single game and they lost. In Group 2, I did not expect John Deere to not make it out first, but they didn't. In Group 3, I didn't think Horsch could beat JZD, but they can. I love World Championships. This is awesome. Everything is just crazy.
I know, it's just awesome, right? I mean, anything. This is the cool thing about FSL. Anything can happen. Like all the teams, we expect that. You can look at the paper, right? You can see how you can look at the current circuit points for each team and the tactics that they do. But they just come in surprises all the time. Each time there's an FSL, each time there's another match, there's always something that comes on, and it just surprises, right? And it's definitely this is a cool thing. This is a great thing about FSL. I love it.
It is fantastic. And as I said, the really close group is ahead 7 days from now, next Sunday again.
Yes, we've got the death
at noon German time, 11 a.m. English time, UK time. And depending on your time zone, whenever that is, it's the close group. This is the one we expected to be the easiest to predict group. And we can't. We just can't.
Now we can't predict this. Like this match just here, you can see Horsch and JZD. This time just here, this could go any way. Like we now know that Horsch has the ability to be able to win JZD. They're very, very good. So, yeah.
And what they now need is one more fast game out of the next two. Let's see what they pick up. And, I expect Horsch to do the exact same thing. No. You're not getting the tally again.
Yeah, they're trying to give them some disadvantages now. They do not want them to win and do the same methods of what they just did.
No. And I wonder if the JCB will stay open because it hasn't been banned yet.
No, not yet. I suspect it will. There we go.
Oh, yeah, there it is. I was about to say, maybe we see it for the first time in like 5 months or something because this thing is always banned. It's the fastest and most agile tractor we have. Is that agile? Correct? I think it is.
Yeah, agile. Yeah, it's very, very nimble and agile. Yeah, 100%. But it has been used before, the JCB, but very rarely it gets used. And look, the two big tractors again, they're being picked. The Deutz just there. And the Fendt.
There's no disadvantage in taking the Fendt over the Deutz. They have the same top speed. They are both very powerful. So having one of these two is basically, it's massive for both of them.
Yes.
And Horsch, again, going for a very quick setup or very fast setup. The New Holland being a very fast tractor. I expect them to go with care wheels now. Probably the
it looks like it's going to be care wheels. Puma.
It's the case, but it's care wheels.
Yeah, that case is actually quite a powerful tractor. It's like 200 or something horsepower, right? So, you definitely can move the bales with that thing and do some baling with it as well.
One stacker. It is an interesting change. So
it's different than the last round, so things would change.
Yeah, so that means you need to get two harvesters and two balers because you have two tractors that pull the balers. If you only have one bale press now, you have one tractor basically being completely useless. He can't pick up bales and stack. He can't do shit. You need two bale presses. This is the most important thing right now. Both teams are going for the exact same tactic here with slight edge chip tuning. So let's have a look and see if both teams get two bale presses or if one basically doomed themselves by picking just the bad tractors.
Yeah, so somebody in the chat says, why is the telehandler banned? It's banned because I think the other team doesn't want the other team to use it because they've used that to obviously get loads of bales on the conveyor.
Yeah,
so they're just trying to give them a disadvantage. That's what they're doing. They're trying to win them over.
I think Horsch, JCT banned that one because Horsch was just able to win it with that. And
exactly,
Horsch is going for the Krone press. The question is, are they fast enough to get it?
Yeah, what are we going to see just there? This is when they're jumping in the vehicles, and essentially they need to get these vehicles off the podium. Last week, John Deere didn't manage to get the whole combine off the podium, and they left the pipe on half of the pod just there, and they didn't get the John Deere combine. Another team got it right, so they have
Marcel,
to... Oh, no, get the baler. Get it quick. And yeah, they have to get this off, like, so fully.
Two Baylors, four Horsh. The Krone went over to JCD earlier, I believe. Yeah, it did. So
yeah, and the combines are already out. You can see the ideal just here. This is JZD. JZD are out, and they are off. And then you also have Horsh as well. This is Horsh. Horsh. You see the John Deere combine going a different direction. I would presume now the New Holland combine just here. Deutz Freak, he's going to be heading straight to the Auger trailer. That's usually what we see, right? We usually see them going straight to the. And some teams go into the other end of the field. So it seems like that's what they're doing.
Yeah. So both teams should be happy with what they got. The Deutz here dropping the weight to get a little bit more speed out of it.
Yeah, I mean, that'll give you some more speed.
Yeah. Both teams should be happy with what they got because they both got two bale presses, as we said, with the setup they had. Only getting one would be a disaster. So, yeah, it's a fair match. Let's see what comes out of it.
And you can see, I think this is the very first bale being taken to the barn. This is going to score them, depending on where they put it, it's going
to
score them
40
points.
They have to put it down because
points.
They don't have a lift.
Yeah, yeah, true. Yeah.
Yeah, and they do. Just, Mr. Marcel making sure the 40.
So this is going to score them 20 points. There we go. First bale.
Yeah. So usually if you put it down there, it's not really scoring double points. It's more denying the points from the opponent. Because 20 points, that's exactly what you get if you put the bale on the conveyor belt as well. So there was no points to be won with that action. It's just Porsche making sure JZD will not get 40 points, basically.
Yeah.
And that's a good thing to do. It's a very good start. So, preparation phase again.
Yeah, we're just
setting up everything.
We're getting the bales. Harvesting takes place. I'm really looking forward to seeing what the different tactics. I mean, they have different types of vehicles this time. They've gone a little bit different than the last round, so I'm really looking forward to see what they do later on once things start heating up.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it's going to be quite interesting to see. Yeah. It seems like they're changing things up this time around.
Yeah, and in the beginning, you have seen that JCD was a little bit ahead in time. They had the harvesters on the field already, while the New Holland harvester was still on its way to the field. So Horsh being a little bit slower than they were last game, that means that JCD is faster again, at least has been faster in the beginning. And if they can keep this up, if they are faster, I think they have a very high chance of beating Horsh. Because we have seen that if Horsh is not fast enough, JCD is just, they are so good in everything they do, that if you are not fast enough, you're not winning. So for Horsh,
yeah,
they need to make up these seconds.
Yeah, JZD, they are such a good team, and they can. I think they've got a pretty good chance of beating Horsh. But as we just saw, Horsh can actually win JZD. So
absolutely,
this could go either way. It really could. And
yeah, and I would love JZD to win that one. I want game three.
Yeah,
please.
I want game three as well, because today then because it would be over if whoever wins this. If Horsh wins this just here, today would be over, right?
Yeah.
So yeah, because Amazon kind of they didn't get through earlier on because of the internet connection. Today has obviously been slowed down. It's not going to be going on for as long. And we want a game three. So hopefully JZD wins this.
Yeah. I mean, usually, you know, as a caster, we should not take a side here. But it's not about wanting JZD to beat Horsh. It's just us wanting to have game three and then see who wins. I don't mind either team winning, but I would love to have one more game to cast with you.
Yeah, I mean, it's just great. We just love commentating. It's an awesome thing.
Yeah, it is a lot of fun. I love being the caster. Yeah. Oh, that was
and there
nice.
We go, straight over the bridge.
I can jump as well.
Yeah, but he was going over just then with some bales, so you got to be careful when you're doing that. Someone says, are you guys back tomorrow? No, we will be back next week, next Sunday. It'll be me and Virtual Farmer next Sunday with Group Stage D. And next week, all the teams next week, the four teams next week, they are really, really close to each other with circuit points. So that's going to be really interesting to see. So, we should get quite a few matches with them.
It will be awesome next week. I'll not be here next week. I will be the head judge next week, being basically behind the cameras, making sure that everything is going well. But for this week, it's me. Next week, it's Virtual Farmer, this slacker who's just in the chat watching us work.
Yes, VF's in there.
Can't believe you did that to us, Alex.
I think he said he was getting lunch or something. That's why he was watching.
Yeah, I know. He doesn't have the time. Otherwise, I mean, I've never seen Alex going, no, I don't want to do this. He loves it. Pretty much every one of our casters just loves it. We have enough casters,
really,
obviously,
is.
To substitute them in and out.
Yep.
But doing summer, doing Corona, sometimes it's even me.
Yeah, I mean, I just think it's great that we can do this off screen as well without being in the studio. We've managed to do it. It's just great. I think we can, you know, we've managed to still keep FSL going. We've adapted, and now we have these group stages as well. It's it's great what we've done.
Yeah, it took us some time. That's why technically World Championship would already been over, right?
Yeah, this would have been over.
FarmCon
now. Yeah.
was in like 4 weeks ago, and that would have been the finals. But we obviously had to come up with a solution to make sure that this is still going, especially because we really want the final teams to play each other offline. So what happens now is with the online group stage that we see now, we go down to 8 teams, which brings us down to 24 players, and it should bring us down to less than 50 people in total for the finals, and then we can bring in people to Erlangen for the finals to our sports studio. So on September 19 and 20, it will be an offline tournament. You will see the players, you will see the stage, you will see, well, you won't see the proper FSL stage. You will see the sports studio we built. This is our way to get the
I wonder if the English castle will get over next month. I guess we'll see what takes place, right?
I wouldn't bet on it.
No.
I think for the English casters, there's a very high chance that you guys still have to do it remotely.
Yeah.
But at least we get the players in. That would be awesome.
I guess we'll see.
Yeah, we'll see.
Yeah. Anyway, we might have some kind of miracle in the world.
Who knows?
Yeah.
But as I said, finals will be there.
Yeah. Anyway, you can see this is the moment when things start heating up. The drone will be dropping. The drone drops any minute. It's between the 6 to 8 minute mark. You can see the drone over there. It's flying around. And all the combines now, they're starting to unload into the auger trailer. And as soon as they pick this drone drop, they're going to be taking this auger trailer straight to the unload point. And out of these two combines here, the black one, the Fendt just there, that has the most grain. So I suspect that to probably be unloading for a little bit longer.
There is the drone.
And there is the drone, everyone.
Thank you, Tech, for showing that one.
Really, really cool. And like we were saying earlier on, the drone actually, it sort of hovers in between. I think it's like a triangle, isn't it, right? In the middle of the three players.
Exactly.
It hovers in between the three players. And it drops the drone drops somewhere in between them. And the players tend to sort of play around the drone as much as they can when they know it's going to drop.
So it seems that JCT, again, is a little bit faster than Horsch with everything they do. They are pretty much ready to get the grain boost if they want to. It looks that the Horsch auger wagon is very full already. I haven't seen the one from Team Horsch. We have to be careful here. The Horsch auger wagon is not necessarily the one by Team Horsch.
And Horsch is there to get the
bail boost. That was nicely done.
Yeah, it was straight out of the tractor, jumped straight into it. Now he's back in again, and now he's off. And there's quite a few bales there already as well for Team Horsch.
Yeah, that was exactly what the doctor ordered, because as we said, the harvesters for JCT were on the field earlier. So JCT was probably ready for more grain.
He kind of picked the bale up and it flipped, and then he couldn't get the bale on far enough because there was a bale in front of him.
Yeah, but he's already stacking bales. So tiny advantage for Horsch. They made up for the seconds they lost. Now they are faster, and now we'll see what happens after the 1 minute and 20 are left.
Yeah, and we now have, we now have JZD bringing in some more bales. This is the chrome bale just here. It can hold 3 bales, and they're dumping them all out just there. And then he's not trying to dump them on top of each other. It's like a dual bale.
No.
But he's put them there, and you can see loading up the conveyor right now. And then we have Krone as well just here loading them up. It's, the points as well. You can see the points looking pretty cool. They're quite close to each other. 20 points out currently.
Yeah.
I'm sure we'll see that change.
If you have a guy like Hyper on your team in JCD, you don't need to stack them up. Because look at how smooth.
Yeah, look how fast he is. His name matches him perfectly. Hyper, right? It's just fast.
He's hyper stacking.
It's like forward, back, on. Forward, back, on. Like, it's so fast. And they're all on so precisely as well. There we go. Yeah.
This guy is just really, really good.
He is really good. There's quite a few good. There's actually quite a few good stackers in the FSL. Yeah. There really is. There's quite a few. There's some good ones.
It's one of the disadvantages Horsch has. They don't have this perfect stacker. Monty is not up there with Hyper and Lucas and Flexo Fabio and all these other stackers. He's just slower, and you can tell by the points right now that he is, right? Hyper is just way better getting ahead for JCD.
I mean, just look at this. He's just like on. Now it's that, and then he goes straight back to it again. It's like it's perfect positioning. It's doing such a great job. And you can see just there the bales going on. It's 360 there to JZD and 290 to Horsch.
So clear advantage for JZD here.
Yeah. And we now have the multiplier.
Both teams are ready. Both teams are ready. JZD is like, you are not faster than us again. You've done that once.
Yeah, I wonder if who's gonna end the multiplier in each of us favor. I guess we'll see.
It should be JCD because I think it looks like Wigan was fuller. Yeah, look at
Maybe not. Maybe it'll be on point, like on 2.0 still. It could actually be on 2.0. No, okay, there we go. JCD, it seems like they had just a little bit more. Just a tiny little bit.
Advantage JCD, and that's a good position for them to be in. So Horsch has to make up for it.
Yeah, they need to make up for this now. And I mean, it's not too much really in Horsch's disadvantage, but it is in their disadvantage. So they need to get more bales, really. And JZD, I'm sure we'll see them. You can see a shot just here of all the bales being picked up. Oh, it went in then.
The flashing green rectangles are indicators for the bridges. If they are green, that means the bridge is down and you can drive over it. If they are gray, that means the bridge is up and you can't. And if they are flashing, that means the bridge is coming up or down in that very second.
Yeah, the bales also dictate the other team as well. The bridges, that if you drive over a bridge and if your bridge is going down, the other teams will be going up. So, that's one of the ways you can actually sort of look at this just there. They're going over the bridge with bales on it. Oh, he managed to do it. So yeah, this is another way where you can sort of, sort of play with the other team really and knock them off track with the bridges and also with the multiplier as well.
Yeah. So I see people going, this is game over unless they do something stupid. I wouldn't count out Horsch just yet. They are a good team.
Horsch are good. I mean, we just saw Horsch win a few minutes ago, right? So they have the chance, everyone. 100%. I mean,
definitely advantage JCD, no question about it. And you can tell they are leading in points. They are super fast right now. Bales coming in left, right, and center. But so is Horsch. And there are still 3 minutes left. So let's see what happens.
I mean, if JZD wins this, there will be another match next. And they'll be going against each other again. And whoever wins that will then be the winners. And they will get into the qualifiers for next month. And whoever loses will, they'll be out of FSL this year. So
yeah, they will come back next season. I'm sure we're going to see both teams back next season. I would be very confused if we wouldn't see Horsch and JCD.
Maybe different players,
who knows? But
yeah, I mean, I think me and VF was talking about this. There is a chance that the players might change teams and things like that. They might change brands, you know.
It's already starting. You see already teams going, hey, you know, if you are a good player, there are other teams approaching you going, hey, want to play for us next season? So it already starts. Of course it does. In every game, in every sport, it just does. If you are a good player, there are other teams trying to pick you up. So we might see some changes in team setups. We might even see some brands disappear or some new brands come up. Who knows? I don't expect these two to disappear.
I mean, this is the thing. We might get some mega teams next season because if teams pick the best of other teams as well and they bring them in, I mean, we might get to see some really big mega teams next season and ones that are absolutely just, you know, even better than Trailbog, let's just say. Trailbog might get some other people to join them. I guess we'll see, right? And we could get some really good, powerful teams.
Yeah. Because this first season, a couple of these players have never played competitively before. So you wouldn't know what you get, right? But now after this is like tournament number 12 or something, after all these tournaments, you know exactly who does what. And I'm quite sure there will be new teams forming. And of course, there are new friendships forming, so maybe you join another team just because you want to play with your friends. A lot of options. We will see in a couple of months.
For now, we are at World Championships here.
JCD winning that one.
But first of all, we have next month is going to be the big month. I mean, all the top teams are going to be going against each other next month. That's just going to be awesome to see. I cannot wait for that. Anyway, we are off to 30 seconds. We have 30 seconds left. And look at the scores right now. JCD are currently... They are currently a lot higher than Horsch. I mean, they are kind of... I was going to say obliterating them. I wouldn't really say that. They're not too... that. I mean, they're quite far off, but they're not that far. I don't know, 100 points or so. But they're definitely higher than them. And we have 15 seconds to go, so...
Yeah. I mean, if Horsch wants to... We're going to go to game three, guys.
Yeah, if Horsch wants to win this, they need to get the bales in now. But it doesn't look like they are going to. It looks like it's going to be a win for JZD. And it looks like we're going into game three. So, awesome stuff.
And I'm just seeing people going, how long has this been a thing? Well, this is... Technically, it's the second season.
Yeah.
It's the first season that it is the Farming Simulator League. It was named Farming Simulator Championship before, and it wasn't a proper league. It was a tournament series, basically. That started in 2017, so 3 years ago on Agritechnica. the league itself started back at FarmCon 2019. That was July last year. So this league is going on for 14 months. And we aim for like a 12-month season. But because of Corona, you know, it's longer than
it's just gone longer, expected right? it to be. Yeah, I mean, this should have been over by now at FarmCon. But yeah. it's going on. We have these group stages, which is okay. I mean, these group stages are pretty cool. I think they're quite cool.
Yeah.
I think it's really cool how they're doing
it. We would have had the group stages at FarmCon as well. But
yeah. I like the group stages. They're really good. Anyway, up next, again, we have the teams again. This is, you can see just there in the bottom left, it's best of three. And both teams have won a match. So that means whoever wins this next match are going to be the winners. They're going to be getting qualified. And they're going to be going into next month.
Yeah, this is the do or die game, basically.
Yeah,
losing, you are out. If you are winning, you face Burning Gamers on September 19th.
Yeah, this is definitely, if any team is going to be pressured today, I mean, they've all been pressured, right? Every single match today. But if you're going to be pressured today, it is this match. You are either in today or you're out. It's simple as that. Whoever wins this next match. So, yeah.
And this will be the last match of today, because this is the last match of the group. Group C will be done by the end of this match.
Yes. King 4502. Hello. You say, why are here Silver News? Yes, I'm here. Welcome.
Yeah. Question that I tried to pick up, but I forgot which one it was.
Okay. Yeah, I'm looking forward. I'm wondering if they're going to change the tactics on this next round just here. Horsch obviously won the first one. They won by being much faster, right? So, I guess we'll see. I think they're going to try and go faster if they can. But I think JZD are going to try and knock them out and try and not let them do that.
Because what we have seen, if both teams are more or less at the same speed, JZD is just better. They have the better stacker. They have the better players. They are the better team. So, right. Horsch being the underdog, thank you, Tech. Tech was just throwing me off here by talking into my ear. In order for Horsch as the underdog to win this, they need to do what they did in game one. They need to be faster than JCD because they are not better, so they need to get more out of every single second they have. That's the only way for them.
Yeah. I just want to say, I really like that guy's shirt, like with the cow on it. That thing's really cool. I like that.
That's from the Agritechnica merch store, by the way.
Yeah, that's nice.
I like the left one more that says, look, I am your farmer, but that's just because I like
it. Is it really?
It does. I love the... And I think... On the backside, it says you don't know the bower of the farm side.
Right.
Totally okay. my humor.
Oh. Anyway, any moment, everyone, we should be joining the game. 10 seconds. Okay. 10 seconds, yeah. Everyone.
So we are ready for the final match of today. JCT or Horsch? One will go through. One will go home. Who will it be?
Who's it going to be? Wait. This is going to be a very pressured round. JZD, a very, very good team. But we do know Horsch, and Horsch are good as well. And we do know Horsch does have the chance to beat them. It all really depends on what they get here in a lot of ways. How are they going to try and go for a fast round? Are they going to try and beat them with fastness? That's the only way, right?
They have to beat them with fast.
Yeah, that's the only way.
And I love on the player pictures how Deutz Freak, the one with the beard, you know, looks like he's pretty much the same size as everyone else. This guy is like 2 meters 5 tall.
I think they must have like narrowed him down in Photoshop because he might have been off the screen.
Yeah. Actually, that was actually how we shot it. We were like, can you sit down or something? Because we can't just take a picture. It was amazing. So let's see what happens here. JZD is not banning any of the...
Yeah, the telehandler's been banned. Things, so that means they can't use Horsch. That. Yeah, Horsch cannot use the telehandler this time, which is what they used to win them earlier on.
So, yeah, but it was not only about that one. It was about fastness.
Yeah. It was an attribute, I guess, of winning, but not the only thing.
To go over to Horsch now.
Oh no,
the Steyr is open.
Wow.
I didn't realize the Steyr is open. That one is just, it's super fast. It has narrow tires.
So yeah, we start, and there's the Fendt, everyone. Ooh. Look at that, it takes the whole screen. Yeah, this is
going
to be a little bit different.
Speed and power. I don't know what their plan is, but these two tractors, both 63 kmh, and they probably go for the New Holland as the third one now. Yeah, they do.
Yeah,
this is a
New
super
Holland's
fast
a good tractor.
JCD is like, you are not faster than us. Let's pick fastest combination we can.
As we know, they've gone for a little Fenton. That's pretty nice to see. We don't see that too often.
Yeah, no, but for JCD, all they did really is defend their speed. These three tractors on the right-hand side, they are the three fastest tractors pretty much you can get with everything that's banned right now.
Yeah, I think
JZD
it looks like JZD are like, you beat us with being fast, we're going to beat you now with being fast.
Yeah, we are taking the fastest we can get. Come at us. And now it's all about the rush down to the pots.
Yeah, and you could... Yeah. And can... the... Sorry, go on.
Yeah, I was about to say, if they can get something awesome, if they get a good start, maybe get 3 harvesters or something, they're in a good position. If they don't have a good start, JCT has a clear advantage. If it's even after the rush phase, JCT has an advantage because they're the better team. So let's see what they go for.
Someone says they might go for a rush. That could be possible. They do have some fast tractors.
No, what they're going to do for Horsch is they will go for 3 combines. I guarantee you that.
Yeah, I think that's probably the most.
They won't
thing.
Make it 2 already in the hands of JZD. So
yeah, they just want to they want to win them with fast tractors. They know that Horsch managed to beat them previously with fast tractors. If they can get Horsch to have slower tractors or just normal tractors, right? Then
Monty, you really need to get into that one. Otherwise,
get into the combine. Get it off the pod now. Go.
Okay, they have 2 combines.
And
that's good news. And they have 3 balers. Horsch managed to get 3 balers. Where is the 4th one?
Okay,
where is the 4th one? Did JZD get the baler? Yeah, they do.
Okay, so like we say, everyone, whoever wins this round is in. Whoever loses it is out. So these 2 teams just here, they are currently 1-1.
Yeah, and Horsch did everything they can to ensure that they have a speed advantage. They have the Fen Press, they have the Krone Press, and they have the New Holland. So they are slowing down JZD by not allowing them to have 2 bale presses. This is big for Horsch.
This is really cool because JZD, they have a lot of fast tractors and things. They've picked the fast tractors, but then Horsch comes along and gets lots of different other fast types of things. They get the balers and things like that, right? So
That's exactly what we've spoken about last match. So JZD only has 1 front loader and they only have 1 bale press. That means 1 tractor is completely useless for them later in the game because you can't go on the field and get bales because you don't have a fork. You can't pull a baler because there is no baler for you. You only have 1.
No,
so
right.
1 tractor, completely useless for JZD. Yeah, you can see him down them a lot.
You can see him flashing his lights there. He's all happy. He's thinking he's gonna. I think he thinks he's gonna win. There's a chance.
Well, Horsch knows that with 3 balers and only 1 forklift on the other side. Is it forklift, by the way, in English?
Yep. Telehandler, nice. Forklift. Yep.
Nice. Advantage Horsch. Clear advantage Horsch because, as I said, JCT basically playing with only 2 players later in this game. Of course, right now it's not a problem. They have 2 harvesters, all good.
Right.
They can have all 3 guys working. But as soon as it comes to pressing and stacking bales, JCT is basically just playing with 2 people.
Yeah, and you can see just there, Mr. Marcells, he unhooked from the Chrome Baler just there, and he hooked onto the Auger trailer. Just opening it up, right? Just opening it up in a few minutes' time. When the combines are ready to unload, they can get into there as fast as possible. They have to get those Auger trailers opened up.
Yeah, and can you imagine if this game goes well for Horsch, JZD getting out, not out of groups? I expected them to be number 1 in this group.
Yeah.
But now they are back to the wall to get out of the tournament. This is insane.
Yeah, I can remember earlier on today, before we actually started, you said, oh, no, it's going to be easy. It's going to be like 2. There's going to be 2 matches with JZD and Horsch. And and that'll be it, right? I guess Horsch has surprised us, right? Horsch does have the potential to beat JZD.
Pleasantly. I'm surprised.
Pleasantly surprised. Yeah, that's right. Yep.
Yeah, need to work on my pronunciation. German pronunciation, right here. I mean, everyone hears that I'm German, quite sure, but I try to improve.
That would be a huge upset from VF. Yeah, that would. I mean, JZD, they're so good, right? And if they lose this, it just shows that. Yeah. I don't know what to say. I mean, it just shows Horsch, are good.
Oh,
right?
If that one goes in, but I'm not sure it will.
It's kind of just over the edge. It might not.
Yeah, it will, and then it's 40 points. Nicely
okay, first
done.
Bail.
First bail, 40 points.
The Horsch got doing the first everything.
They are fast. They are fast.
Yeah, Horsch are just at it today.
Oh my god, and JCD is just there. What are they doing?
What are they
pushing
doing?
Around the things.
Like they're crashing into the Coon Baler. Seems like he's opening the top. There you go. And he's just pulling out of the field.
They probably know that with the Deutz and the Fendt there, they needed 2 balers, so they are probably a bit disappointed in their start right now. And I don't know.
And again, look, I mean, you can see the Fendt. I mean, there's a little Fendt pulling the Chrome Baler. The thing is, I'm just going to say, in real life, in a little tractor like that, probably wouldn't be able to pull that big baler. That's why I'm so surprised that it can pull it. It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
But yeah, but the good thing about these little tractors, like the New Holland just here as well, it's super nimble, right? You can it has the telehandler on the front, so you can what's it called? I forgot. It's got a complete out of my brain. But it's got that on the front, so you can attach to the so you can click to the bales. Wow, and you can put them onto the conveyor.
The fork.
Forklifts. Yes. Complete out of my brain.
So it's on this guy to save freeze. The game. Hyper needs to be. Not only hyper, but super
Bale
hyper.
Balefork. Yes.
Balefork, yeah. And Jose, I don't know how you want to pronounce this. He's preparing everything. But yeah, it all comes down to stacking for JCD now. Because they're on the back foot, their stacker needs to come up with a solution for the problem they face in about 2.5 minutes from now.
Yep, 2.5 minutes. That's This is just the preparation phase, everyone. This is like, we were saying this last week, this is when everything is really calm. Everyone's just, I mean, everyone's bailing, they're bringing the bales to the shed, but there's no, I mean, I guess we're saying calm, this guy's crashing into a bale here, so it's probably not. But, yeah, I mean, this is usually the most relaxing part of the game. Everything starts to really heat up below the 10-minute mark, and we are below that now, so things are starting to get faster now. You can see everyone's now taking the bales to the shed, ready to unload later on.
Let's talk about wind conditions here. For JZD, they will probably have at least a harvester out there all the time. So I guess the win condition for JZD would be to take the grain boost and make sure that they get as much as possible out of the bales they have. Because as we said, one tractor is just completely useless for them later in the game. So the win condition for JZD would be to take grain boost. Lucky for them, it's their preferred tactic anyway. So they should have a clear idea of what to do now, but they're on the back foot for Horsch. The win conditions is pretty clear.
Yeah, it's pretty clear.
Doing what you do and make sure that you put bales on that conveyor belt all the time, because you can with all the bale presses you have. And as long as you get in points all the time, you will be ahead of Jason.
Yeah, we have the John Deere just there unloading into the auger trailer, because in around 20 seconds time now, at some point in between the 6 to 8 minute mark, we're going to see the drone drop. And what do you think they're going to go for? Do you reckon they're going to go for the bale boost or the grain boost? What are you thinking?
So for Horsch, it would be better to go for the bale boost, definitely. Because you have more bales and you can have more bales. And, you know, it would help. For JZD, they basically need the grain boost.
Yeah, they need it.
Yeah, because they need to have that multiplier in their favor, because they have a basically lost tractor later on.
Yeah, because...
There we go. Power up super early. 10 seconds grain into boost. The window. It's already there.
Okay, so then, sweet. Yeah, so they've got the grain boost.
The grain boost. Was that an accident? Can we have a replay?
Oh, that could have been an accident. Yeah, the thing is, like, JZD need the grain boost and they now have it. Reason for that is because they just don't have enough bales. So for every one of those bales they put on, now if they can get the multiplier up right, and also now with the grain boost, you know, those bales are definitely going to be worth more. So
it's now in their advantage. And that might be a disaster for Horsch.
I'm
sure that wasn't planned.
Yeah, it might not be.
They're not even ready.
Yeah, it might be, yeah.
This
I kind of feel like it probably was. Yeah. It could have dropped straight on the head or something and picked it up by accident. That does happen.
Yeah, yeah. And it most likely is that, because Horsch was not ready to take the grain boost. I'm sure they didn't want it anyway, because it is a disadvantage for them. And now they are in a lot of trouble, because JZD will be there first. Of course, they have the Steyr so they can go through the field. It's not too bad, but it's bad enough already. Look at this. They just started.
Well, the thing is,
JCD's already unloading.
You say they can go through the field. The actual auger trailer itself, that can actually kill the crop. It can flatten the crop.
Yeah.
You can see behind, there's actually a trailer of where he's just gone through the field. So even though the stayer can go through the field, the auger trailer can't. So,
but it's still faster, though, than taking
it is.
And now JCD is like, okay, that's our chance. That one we needed. 28 points per bale. Thank you for that. And
you can see just
to try to get points.
It just completely
needs to do something.
It just unhooked then from the bale, and he was like, it swung back around really fast and get in there to put the bales on. And obviously, Monty is pretty good at stacking the bales.
Yeah, but this will be a huge advantage for JZD with the grain boost. That's why I said you don't want to have the grain boost if you are Horsch. Maybe they get it back to one. Maybe they get it back to one. No, 1.8. Not good for Horsch at all.
This is not good at all.
JZD should be super happy with how this played out so far.
Yeah, we were thinking that Horsch may not win. May win this as a chance. I mean, there's still a chance they could win. 5 minutes is a lot of time.
Yeah, but they need to stop doing this weird thing with the bales and start putting them on the belt.
They need to stop messing about. There's crashing. Like, what? That Bale is not good to put on the conveyor right now. You need to get it straight.
Now we are in that position I spoke about earlier. JCD now is playing with two people. Like,
right.
You know, they can't use that third tractor. As you can see, Melly is in the ideal, just keeps harvesting because there's nothing he can do. His tractor, the Deutz, completely useless.
Right. And I love the first person view. This is awesome. Like, you can actually see up close what they're doing. And maybe he'll actually be driving the tractor in first person himself. Some people do like to drive like that, and you can actually see what's in front of you much more. So that could be potentially what they're doing.
Yeah, and for Horsch, they do exactly what they needed to do now. They have just bales coming in left, right, and center. They have two stackers. So what they need to do now is they need to keep pressing bales. Yes, they get less points. However, if they have way more bales, and again, while this guy is bringing in bales, he can't do anything else, and there's no other stacker.
No.
So for Horsch, they need to win by bales.
Yeah, they need to get these bales on.
They need to get something into the silo again, but I don't think they will.
On JZD has the advantage of the multiplier. You can see 2.2 just there. Their conveyor is going. Their conveyor is going 80%, and obviously Horsch is going 120.
222.
But yeah, look at that just there at the top. Scores are currently equal, 2-2-2 for both teams.
Yeah, but you see exactly what I was talking about. There's one guy pressing. There's one guy picking up the bales, and the third guy is just driving around with the ideal because he doesn't know what to do. Anyway, because they don't necessarily need to harvest, right? They are an advantage already. They have a multiplier of 2.2, but he can't do anything else. There's nothing he can do with the Deutz.
Yeah, this is going to be interesting to see. We have 4 minutes left now, everyone. Horsch, really, I saw someone in chat saying they need to pull a finger out Horsch. They do. They need to get moving, get these bales on ASAP. Yeah,
And Horsch, they are like, okay, we don't care about this multiplier anymore, even if they most likely know that the multiplier will go even more in JCD's favor soon, because that's the only thing they can really do with the third tractor. They can just take care of the multiplier. Other than that, there is nothing to do. So what they do is they get more bale presses on and will just keep pressing bales and try to score more points by just having more bales. Because multiplier, this one is not going back into Horsch's favor, ever. Will make sure that this stays like this.
100%. Yeah, and the good thing about Horsch though is they do actually have the baler streak, right? So they do have more balers to produce more bales. So it is possible still for them to win, I think. I mean, you can see Horsch are now at 330. It is still possible. They do have more bales coming in.
And here's what we are expected to do. JCD, they use the third tractor. They don't know what to do with it, so they make sure they get even more points out. So 24 to 16 per bale now. That means that you need three bales to match two bales from JCD. And this is advantage JCD.
Look at what I just said. Dual bales going on at once just there. That's pretty awesome.
Yeah. And it now is JCD, that's another about 100 points coming in right there.
Yeah, that is
48 times two.
So oh, look at that. What the hell? He's doing like, he was doing wheelies just then. Did you see that?
I don't think that was planned though.
I know. It won't be planned.
this will be such a close match because JCD is in such an advantage when it comes to the grain boost. But, not sure if Horsch is doing anything about it. I don't think they will.
Whoever wins this, though, there's no more matches after this, everyone. This is the third match today. So whoever wins this is through. And whoever loses this is out. So, this is the one. We have 2 minutes left. You can see just here, these two teams right now. If a team is going to be pressured today, it's these ones just now. We have literally 1 minute, 40 seconds left.
And this game is as close as it can get. Horsch in the advantage with the bales. JCD in a huge advantage with the grain boost or the multiplier.
Yeah.
So there's no prediction who wins this. 1 minute,
gonna be a close
call. I have no idea.
It's going to be a close call, definitely. There's another in-cab view of the fence just here. Straight on.
Pretty sure he's playing in-cab. And you can see that JCD is catching up. Now they are even in the lead because they have this very high multiplier. However, Horsch does have the bales left, right, and center.
Yeah, so I found that really cool that he's actually playing in the cab.
Yeah. A lot of stackers do that. But he needs to focus more. Again, the only thing they have now is time. They need to keep the bridges up. They need to make sure that JCD is not getting bailed.
Oh, it's tipped up. No.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
That can't happen.
That is
this
not good.
Can't happen with a minute to
JCD,
go.
JCD needs
disaster
to get up.
Disaster for JCD.
Oh, no. Oh, he's done it. Yes.
And he still has the bales, though.
Oh,
he's
my
like, goodness. Oh, yeah, well. whatever happens to me, I'm not losing bales. I'm the master of bales.
That was not good, though. That slowed time down a lot.
That might actually be what Horsch needed. That was exactly the 15 seconds
that slowed,
they couldn't lose. And yeah, no bales for Horsch anymore.
It seems like there's some bales coming in, but they need to get them out on the conveyor ASAP. Or in the bottom drawer, at least.
At least in the bottom drawer. A couple of them down there. This is so close. 20 seconds.
This could be a win for Horsch.
In the lead by 100
points. Like we were saying early on, if JCD lose this, this is not goal.
And these four are not enough. They are not enough. That should be it.
Horsch, I think Horsch has won.
Should beat JCD and make it to the finals.
Big congrats. Yes, 4-3-2-1. Big congratulations.
GG Horsch.
There we go, everyone. Wow, Horsch has actually won. Horsch, that is great.
Made it to the finals and JCD is out of the tournament.
Oh my day. So there we go. I mean, we were just saying that JCD is such a good team and, you know, compared to Horsch, and Horsch just completely whooped their ass and just, you know. Wow, that is great. So, congrats to Horsch. Horsch are now in. They are now qualified and they are now in the FSL finals next month. They have a chance to win.
This is absolutely insane. Very well played by Horsch. It's nice to see these guys are back on track to be a team, you know, a force to reckon with.
Yeah.
I didn't expect it either.
We were just saying before the whole thing earlier on today, me and you were saying, like, JCD, we think JCD are going to win. Two rounds, that'll be it. Two matches against them. They're going to whoop them. But no, Horsch has just come and completely... that is just great. It was a close round, but they managed to win. So, big congrats. Yeah.
Upset of the season. Well, it's up there with Trelleborg losing against Team of Elite Guys, for sure. These are the two upsets I've never seen. I would have bet money on JCD on this one because they are so good.
Yeah, they are. They're such a good team, right?
Oh, boy. Insanely awesome. Done. GG Horsch, I'm really happy to see you guys are back. Sad for JCD to end the season here, but, you know, it's the World Championships. People have to get kicked out. And we get a couple of replays in a few seconds.
We get some replays.
See how Horsch did it.
Yes. And just to tell everyone in chat as well, we are going to be doing Group Stage D next week. And it's going to be Lande by Astragon, Landwirt, Schaff, Linda, and VK next week. So, yeah, stay tuned for next week. This is when he crashed into the bridge. And the bale actually drops into the, in the UK, we'd call it a dike. So I don't know if you know that word. But yeah, it drops into the dike. And then I think he came and went into the lock, and he actually flipped the telehandler. But he did
manage
to get back off.
He went down there on purpose, you can tell, but...
He went a bit too fast and he flipped. But he managed to get the bale.
Yeah, and they won that one. That was the game Horsch won.
And they went straight over the... This team is crazy. They just went straight over the bridges. It's unbelievable. Yeah, that was such a good replay.
That was absolutely insane.
Yeah, I'm super surprised that Horsch has won.
Yeah, and for the last time today, we mentioned that these guys are not us.
Yes.
That's the German commentators. I know we keep repeating ourselves, but there are people coming in. There are new people watching, and they are always like, oh, why is the sound so bad? Because these are the Germans. You can't hear them unless you are on the German stream over at GiantSoftware.de.
Yes.
Yeah.
Logan in chat says, the casters make it honestly. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Thank you very much, Logan.
Thank you. Good. Glad to hear that you're having fun, because we for sure have fun. Okay. We have a little bit of time
We have a little bit of time to chat. I guess we could chat about next week, I guess. I mean, it's going to be me and VF next week. How do you think it's going to go down next week? Lande, Astragon, by Landwirt, Schaff?
I have no idea. Lande are obviously being the favorites.
They're so close as well on circuit points, right? All those teams. It's going to be...
Even the ones that are not are just so good, like VK. They are just new. And we get the next replay.
Yeah.
Let's have a look.
And here we go. Here's another replay of today's match. And this was when the ideal combine just came in. And look, he actually, he missed the pipe. He jumped out and missed the trailer.
Again, 10 seconds lost. Yeah. Right? These are the tiny mistakes that can make or break you in the end.
Yeah, this is the thing with FSL. Just a tiny little thing like that can break it, right? And yeah, there was the bail boost. Yeah. He got out the Deutz and got back in really fast.
Yeah. I still wonder if the bail boost in game 3 was on purpose or not.
Yeah. And then this guy went straight over the bridge. He didn't lose any bales either. Nearly crashed into the fence.
He should have, though.
Oh, wow. He nearly crashed into the fence as well. He just managed to dodge out of the way.
And you can tell the Germans are talking about the exact same thing. They're like, how the hell did he manage to get over that bridge?
Yeah, so. I mean, the thing is, I mean, if anybody plays Farmsim in the game right now with the bales and things, the bales, you know, you've got to be careful with them, right? In just like real life as well. If you come over, if you did that, the bales would be off. So, he's very lucky this stayed on going over that bridge. And we will have some more replays in 30 seconds.
It's still being prepared by the tech team in the beginning. So let's just have a look at this group. Obviously, Krone won that one. They faced John Deere on September 19th. And now it's fixed that BG by Stark will face Horsch.
Yep.
That's done.
Here we go. We have another replay. Another replay, everyone. Here we go. What is this replay?
Final replay of today.
I think this is going to be a good one. This is going to be for the finals. So you can see, this is... Look at that just there. I don't know how that happened. God. He just picked the bale up and they just flipped back on him. It was like... That was funny.
And then he's just driving around like...
And then he tips up as well. Does he tip up? Is this the time when he tips up? Because he does tip up and do donuts. Oh, I don't know what happens.
But
and then this guy crashes. This guy crashes and tips up as well.
That's what made the game, basically. Ah. That's what decided the game.
Yeah,
these
this
15
not...
seconds here, they decided the game.
Yeah, this knocked like 15 seconds off JZD. It was just terrible, that.
Yeah, and you can see the bales from here, right? There are so many bales, and he could have put them all on the conveyor belt, but he didn't have the time because he tipped.
Yeah, it just tipped, right? Two amazing replays just there. I found that quite funny. So, this has been a really good day. Big congratulations to the two winners today, Krone, and also we had Horsch as well. Big congrats. Now in the qualifiers.
But I'm happy for Horsch. I'm really happy for these guys that they made it in. Still, GG JCD, you guys had a fantastic run. We have to mention again, they came in as a wildcard team. They played some tournaments. They got stronger over the season. They are probably one of the strongest teams in the league right now. They didn't make it to the top eight, but that can happen. This is World Championships. Everything is possible. So, yeah. One more week to go. Next week, the winner of next week, let's chat about that very quick. The winner of next week will face Trelleborg.
Yeah, that's
in
not good.
Quarterfinals. So I'm not even sure you want to win next week.
I mean, the thing is, the teams next week, what are the teams next week? Let's just go over that again. We have 2 minutes. Lande by Astragon, Landwirtschaft, Lindner, and VK. I mean, they're not at the top of the circuit points, right? And they're going to be, one of them are going to be going against the very top. Trelleborg.
Yeah. Which, and the other one is going against Grimme, which is probably one of the strongest team right now. They just destroyed Group 1.
Yeah, exactly. So, it's going to be very interesting to see next week. We will be back next week. It's going to be me and Virtual Farmer next week FSL. That's going to be Group Stage D. And then after Group Stage D, in September next month, it's going to be the Grand Finals. So, you guys got to tune in for that. It's going to be absolutely awesome. And all the teams are going to be competing, all the top teams. It's going to be really cool to see.
Yeah, you totally need to save the date, guys. September 19 and 20 is when the World Championship happens. You totally need to save the date because the best 8 teams of the league are competing and every single game will be super close.
Yeah.
100% sure about that.
Yeah, it's such a good thing. We've got 30 seconds left, everyone. We really appreciate you watching today. It's been great having you. Don't forget to tune in next week. It's been me and Lars. So, thank you for joining me, Lars. It's been great talking to you.
Yeah, thank you for doing that. It was fun, and I was happy to cast with you again after all these months. I think it has been a year.
I think
it has literally been a year since we did that.
Yeah, it was a game.
I think
you
were out for a couple of tournaments.
Yeah, I think it was Gamescom, right? Probably Gamescom.
It has to be, and that was like Gamescom is in 2 weeks from now, right? So it is literally a year.
Anyway, there we go. Anyway, that is everyone. So thank you very much for watching. We'll see you all again soon, and bye for now.
Bye. Have a good time.
See you later, everyone. See you.
To play now, put me in the game now. I came here to prove it, I'm ready to do it. I can't be afraid now. Put me on the stage now. I'm ready to rage now. I feel like an animal stuck in a cage and I'm ready to break out. So what are you afraid of? Those feelings are made of. Get in the game, your moment of fame. Show them what you made of. It's time that we stand up. It's time that we man up. For anyone asking who is the best, we putting our hands up. My time, my time. None of you people can tell me to stop. This time, like the last time. You better get ready to race to the top.
I'm ready to do this. Show you what the truth is. I step on the field, it's time to get real. I'm feeling so ruthless.
My time, my time. None of you people can tell me to stop.
Lower the lights down. Hand over my crown. Hand over my heart. I do this for my town.
stop.